turn the channel on the Keeler Show today.
Why do we always listen?
Keeler's always in the know.
It makes me want to call him
and tell him where to go.
And now let's get things started. Andrew, let's get things started.
It's time to get things started.
On the most sensational, inspirational, celebrational, Keelerational. This is what we call the Keeler Show.
Now back to Keeler.
Do you know how many people died so you could have the right to vote?
You gotta vote. Haven't you seen the Rock the Vote stuff or Puff Daddy's Vote or Die?
All anyone's talking about is this election. It's ruining Twitter.
WYBX 950 and 106.9 FM. The Keeler Show.
Good morning, and it is... Are you ready? Hold it.
Holding.
It's Friday.
Woohoo!
Got a lot of stuff to get into today. Of course, the big parade is tomorrow in Utica. There's a story on our website right now about the fact that Wallet Hub supposed to be have all of these experts on there.
Quote-unquote experts.
Wallet Hub listed, and I've been talking about this all week long. It just burns me up. They listed the 200 best cities in America for the St. Patrick's Day Parade and St. Patrick's celebrations, and zero mention of Utica. Rochester was there. Buffalo was there, which I think Buffalo is probably bigger than Utica. Syracuse was there. New York City was there. No mention of Utica. And, I mean, Syracuse... It's like number 17 in the country. And we're as big, if not bigger, than what Syracuse does. So.
Yeah, and we get a lot of the same people that march in that parade
here. Correct, yeah. And it's the way the community reacts, the way the community parties. And
we're pretty, I mean, we're pretty hardy partiers if you consider the feet of snow that we've had in parades
And had the legendary Dolly Parton blizzard weekend and, you know, just so much. Anyway. There's a story up there on our website at WIBX950.com, but also up there is, I don't know, 60 pictures that were taken by Tom Laughlin of Utica's St. Patrick's Day Parade. These pictures are from 2012, so it's a bit of a decade ago. But,
wow, look at that.
We're bigger now than we were back then, finally getting back from COVID. So, you know, it just doesn't make any sense.
Look at Smiley Palmieri.
I mean, just look at those crowds, right?
I know.
And you're not including us? I just don't get it. How did the Duke game go last night, Davey?
NC State beat them.
Are you
Can
serious?
Can you believe
yes.
that?
I think I'll look up the score was, but
wow, that could be Syracuse. Any team can beat any team on any given day. NC State has turned hot.
At least
at the
I
right
feel
time.
A little bit better that they beat us.
Wow.
Still hate them.
Wow.
I think the score was 74-69.
Wow. So it wasn't even, I mean, it
well,
was.
Well, they were up by four. They were up by three.
Still, there you go, right? There you go. That's what can happen. But if you put yourself in the right position, that's the whole thing. You got to put yourself in the right spot. And have we done that? Syracuse done that? No.
Wah, wah, wah,
Colgate
wah.
Has. Colgate has. And Charleston has.
And I was watching a pregame show last night, and they were talking about their tournament. I was just flipping through channels trying to find something to watch because I couldn't watch basketball yesterday. And Colgate was getting mentioned as being a possible sleeper team in the first round for the tournament to
Watch
be a knockoff.
Watch
them
yeah.
for next week.
Exciting. Okay, and then, of course, that'll all Selection Sunday is coming up on Sunday.
It was 74-69, North
wow.
Carolina State over Duke.
Wow,
so
that's amazing.
North Carolina State will end up playing Virginia today.
Virginia.
And Pittsburgh plays North Carolina.
Okay. And we'll mention, too, that the funeral, do you have the exact name of the place? It's on,
yeah,
what street? Is it Eagle Street?
I will. It's off of Eagle.
Our friend of the show for many, many years, human billboard Fred Dunleavy, an Irishman of his own, in his own right.
That's accurate.
He, his funeral will be today at 4 p.m. It's a one-hour ceremony, and if you can stop by, it would be nice. If you enjoyed any of it, I'll never forget the time that Fred called us one morning, and he was late coming in, and he was at the time with his lovely wife Josephine, and she's the one from Utica who brought him back here. It wasn't me necessarily, although I brought Josephine as an intern to Providence. Josephine came back here with him. And that didn't end well. The marriage didn't end well. But
no.
I'll never forget the time Fred called up and said, "I don't know what I'm going to do." I'm like, "What is wrong, Fred?" "I lost my car. I forgot where I parked it." And literally, he had lost his car. And we had people out searching for his car.
Oh, my
Turns
gosh.
Out he parked it when he was going over to Varick Street and then got a ride home and parked it over in that area by Mother Mary Ann's over in there.
So at least he was drinking and got a ride.
He got a ride, yeah, and forgot and lost his car.
That's going to be
4 p.m. today.
Revels T. Gibson Funeral Home on
Eagle.
Okay,
all right. I'll have to find that one. Not sure where it is. Aldi has confirmed. Are you ready? If you're a grocery store fan of Aldi has confirmed it is closing every single one of its stores across the United States.
What?
For 24 hours. Don't get nervous. For 24 hours, shoppers will have to find an alternative. It will happen on March 31st. The company stores will give their employees Easter Sunday off.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Yeah, that was kind of nice.
I love that Aldi, I'll tell you.
Do not think you're going to run over to Aldi to be able to get your...
last-minute butter sculpture.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I believe you can still get the Daylight Donuts to pick up your snowflake rolls.
Oh, yeah.
But Aldi will be closed. Shoppers will have to plan their Easter Sunday shopping ahead. Aldi has closed its stores for four public holidays each year, and Easter Sunday is one of them, according to the company's website. Okay, Aldi is closed on Christmas Day, New Year's Day, Thanksgiving Day, and now on Easter Sunday. They have over 2,300 stores across America as of the end of last month. So that's I like that as an old-fashioned tradition and something that, you know, it puts your employees before profits.
Yeah, and
so
I mean,
I'm all good with it.
Aldi is a really great store as it is, you know, not only for the produce and the groceries you can get for an affordable price, but the fiancé loves the here today, gone tomorrow aisle because you never know what you're going to get. Just,
I'm going to tell you, and their olive oil, we're like olive oil snobs.
Yeah.
We're very particular about the olive oil because a lot of times you're just getting vegetable oil. It's a big racket, especially if your olive oil comes direct from Italy. It is a racket over there. And also, if your olive oil has like three or four different countries on it, chances are it's been either cut with vegetable oil.
Yeah.
Or that's all it is. It just doesn't taste good. But they are really, really good. You know they're owned by Trader Joe's. The Aldi and Trader Joe's are the same company.
I didn't know that.
I don't know if you saw the pictures. Holy cow. Along the New York State Thruway, and this happened in, I believe, the Hudson Valley. Where was it, Davey?
Between Rochester, between exit 46 and 45.
It was Rochester, Henrietta.
Yeah,
West Henrietta. On the I-90 eastbound lane, the tractor trailer that was going off the road and ended up losing control, its trailer was hanging off the side of the bridge.
Wow.
Look at this picture here. If you haven't seen it yet, look it up on Google it. A major crash left five people, including an infant, injured.
Oh, my God.
When a FedEx truck dangling from an upstate New York bridge Thursday morning potentially caused some accidents. Davey, I'm going to give you this. I'm assuming this is Tonya Powers, right?
Yeah.
And you can take that.
Was that Manaski?
Old school folks.
We'll be right with you.
Old school folks. We're You know, we're running, we're passing iPhones back and forth in order to take calls here.
Was that FedEx driver Manaske?
It was not Manaske, but
thank God. I saw Jeff yesterday.
Anyway, this was unbelievable. Happened about 8:30 in the morning. If you get a chance to check out the pictures, it's something out of like. Luckily, the bridge was over. It was an overpass, and there was a highway underneath it. Otherwise, we would have been looking at the potential for like going down into a huge ravine or something. That would have been crazy. This weekend, St. Patrick's Day weekend, you know, our celebration here is huge and amazing. And Tony J. Powers from Fox News Radio is with us to talk about something of tradition. Drive those snakes out. Tonya, good morning.
Good morning. Yeah, and this is, by the way, the Ides of March, so don't forget
Ides
that.
Ides of March.
Oh, yes. Yeah, watch your back.
There's a lot going on this weekend. Yeah, the parades are being held this weekend. I know here in the city, ours is actually tomorrow.
Ours is as well,
on
yeah.
Sunday.
Yeah,
yeah, because of the fact that St. Patrick's falls on a Sunday
yeah.
this year. Chicago's is tomorrow as well. I know Boston's. I think theirs is... I want to say theirs is on Sunday. I know they've got a couple of them. Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's going to be, you know, there's going to be a lot of partying. Basically, the whole weekend is just going to be one big.
The only thing more exciting than St. Patrick's Day landing on Sunday is when it lands on Saturday. So this is big. There's no doubt.
Yeah, it is. And you mentioned the snakes. Actually, apparently there were, that's one of the like myths associated with St. Patrick's Day.
Mm.
I was not aware of this. Apparently there weren't any snakes around for St. Patrick to banish from Ireland. It's a legend that's associated with St. Patrick, but research suggests that snakes never occupied Ireland in the first place.
Did not know that. Liars!
I did not know that either. There are apparently no signs of snakes in the country's fossil record, which is why they have, you know, made this assumption that there weren't any to drive out. So,
well, actually, you could argue St. Patrick got them out of there. That's why there's no record of them.
You could make the argument that he was quite successful and very very good at his job. So I don't know. That's a good question.
I would always say that New York is like the second best place to celebrate St. Patrick's Day. It's hard not to give number one to Boston, but New York is the place. I mean, it's just the home of all of the foods you want to eat and all of the celebration and you know, St. Patrick's Cathedral. I mean, you know, it's a big spot for St. Patrick's weekend.
It is. The parade itself is just crazy. The revelers, I have covered it on more than one occasion for work, and it is just, honestly, I was not prepared. The first time they ever sent me over to cover this, they were like, hey, I want you to go over and cover the St. Patrick's Day parade. I'm like, okay, cool, it's a parade. And I got maybe a half a block away from our building, which is only a block away from Fifth Avenue.
Right.
And there were already people at like 10:30 in the morning who could not stand up. Just craziness. It was, I was just kind of like, I was not expecting any of this. It was just,
well,
I
have to say that our parade steps off at 10 a.m. 10 a.m. tomorrow. But
it does that too.
They'll be lining up at, you know, 7:30, 8 o'clock. And
yeah.
The green beers are flowing. The Jello shots are just being passed out, and it is quite the celebration.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
It'll be a busy weekend for revelers, as they say.
I know somebody who already started soaking their gummy bears in some sort of liquor days ago.
Is that what they're doing? Yeah. Okay, all right, interesting.
Soak those gummy bears.
That's right. Soak them up. Get them ready there, Tonya. That might be something you want to try. All right. Well, listen, you enjoy St. Patrick's weekend. I've already given warnings to my daughter. So,
Aaron, go bra.
You enjoy it and have a wonderful weekend.
Thank you.
All right. Tonya J. Powers from Fox News Radio.
One of the most important celebrations, and it cannot be missed, is the one today. Happy birthday, Uncle Smitty.
No.
His birthday's Sunday.
Sunday.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Sunday.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
On Sunday.
A couple comments from Mike this morning already. Speaking of teams that haven't gotten in at the right time or haven't gotten hot at the right time, Syracuse is not alone, although there are ties to Syracuse. St. John's with Patino is looking strong. They've gotten hot at the right time.
Well, yeah. And remember, there was all the comments publicly that Patino made against his team that were quite
and it worked.
Harsh.
It worked.
The old Joe Torre method. There.
Today, it's St. John's versus UConn. And he says, I hope St. John's beats UConn today. And then Mike also says, for some, St. Patrick's Day weekend is nothing but a green blur. And boy, that is, there is truth
in my
to that.
Former life.
That's why green's my favorite color.
Is that why it's your favorite? And for St. Joseph's, you're wearing a few days early, you're wearing red. What else do I have? The Trump's document case. Trump's attorneys went in asking to have this whole thing thrown out. The judge said, no, that's premature. No. So that won't happen down in Florida. CNN is reporting this morning. Very interesting. A perplexing animal mystery has stumped scientists during the 2017 eclipse. So prepare yourself for April. During the Great American Eclipse of 2017, zoo animals acted strangely, taking researchers by surprise. The giraffes gathered and broke into a gallop. The tortoises began to mate. The gorillas started getting ready for bed. You know, brushing their teeth and stuff.
Yeah, that's what they were doing.
And these odd behaviors was just a few anomalies that scientists were able to discover out of South Carolina as they observed animal behavior during the eclipse. Now, this one, if you're in the line of this eclipse, expect these animals to act a bit oddly.
You know, we had the Facebook outage or the Instagram outage earlier, and you know, with the eclipse, maybe the aliens are acting strange, kind of like the theme of that movie that the Obamas made.
Could be. The animals go crazy, everything shuts down, we all die.
A bunch of Teslas crash in a row.
anything could happen. I don't know if you've seen that movie. Worst ending ever. What else do we have here? The explorers that were looking for Amelia Earhart's crashed plane say they found it.
Really?
They believe they found it. Now they're going to have to try to prove it. They're saying, yes, we found it. All right, prove it.
Where did it crash? In the Bermuda Triangle or something?
I don't know, to be honest.
Oh, boy.
I didn't follow that story all that much. So lawyers for the families of Sandy Hook have said to Aaron Rodgers, shut the F up. And it was their attorney literally said it that way.
Why? What did he say?
Rodgers is now in the news. And part of this is because he's being named as a potential.
He just can't stay out of it.
He kind of keeps these things going. He, at one point, claimed, as a potential vice president for Robert F. Kennedy, I mean, you know it's not going to happen. Anyway, in 2013, Rogers claimed the Sandy Hook attack was orchestrated by the government and never really happened. The children who died didn't really die. They were actors.
Aaron Jones Aaron Rodgers turned Alex Jones?
And now there are others coming out saying that as of recent times, he's come out with some of these falsehoods. In fact, the last thing saying that these were actors. These kids were actors. Could you please shut the blank up, said Bankston, the attorney for the families. And you can only imagine what someone like him, who's in the limelight, what his words actually, how his words can be so hurtful to family members.
Well, and you would think after the financial pounding that Alex Jones just took on it.
One would think. And what I would say is,
open himself
Aaron Rodgers, just play football.
Yeah.
What are you doing? Why would you get into this? And I got to tell you something. He's gonna say one too many things to the point where the Jets are gonna say, you know what? This isn't worth it.
And well, I don't know about that.
I'm just saying.
But I'm just glad he's not in Green Bay anymore.
Because
it was such
remember,
a nice season with
he's
the
now,
young,
he's
classy
now,
Jordan Love.
He's
awesome.
Now a year older.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, he may not have been playing all year long, but he's a year older. So the older he gets, the less they're going to be willing to stick their neck out. You do not like Aaron Rodgers.
No, I mean he was our quarterback.
He was
I
your
thank
man.
Him for some
when
fun football
man.
To watch,
yeah.
But I've moved on from him.
Well, you know who else? What he? I will tell you what he will start if he doesn't shut up. What he's going to start losing, and maybe already has. I guess he has. Is any of his? You know, all the sponsorships will go away.
Yeah.
Get ready. Billions of cicadas are about to emerge, creating a once in a lifetime spectacle.
Billions and billions.
Practically biblical. Two large broods of cicadas in the Midwest and southeastern U.S. are set to surface simultaneously, something that has not happened in over 200 years.
Mm.
Hopefully we don't see it happen around here, although I'll tell you, the noise from the cicadas last year was incredibly loud. And when we were traveling a couple times, I couldn't believe how loud the cicadas were. And it was actually one would think it'd be a peaceful sound at night. It was one that I somehow hyper-focused on, couldn't get it out of my head, and it kept me up.
So this may be something crazy. I have never seen nor heard ever, I don't think, a cicada.
Oh, yes, you have. Well, I don't know if you've seen one.
I mean,
I'm not saying you've seen one, but you've heard them. You hear them at night.
Yeah, but you hear is that just
you
like
you hear them in the day on a very hot day when you hear the sizzle sound. Let me see if I can help you out. You have definitely heard the sound.
Because, I don't know, it seems like they only come every 16 years, right?
So, No, they're still out there. It's just we're talking about big.
Okay, so there are a limited number of cicadas every year is what you're saying.
I have really no idea, to be honest with you. I'll
look that
up.
Do you have a cicada expert?
723-3824. Cicada, check this out. Now, check this out. This
my cicada.
This is a person with. Let's see if I can get this to actually play. Here we go.
Cicada noise. It literally sounds like running water all day, and you can just see them flying around.
Well, you're talking, man.
All
Shut
day.
Up. Okay, did you hear? Yeah, he did too much. Now that's a cicada. Or that's a cicada. See the picture.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, a lot of times the cicadas will be the color of the tree. When we were in, I don't know, I forgot where we were. The cicadas were really loud. And when you looked at the tree, you could see them on the bark, but they would kind of blend in with the bark of the tree.
Yeah.
Here's one right up close where you can actually. That's the.
Ugh.
That's up close. Isn't that loud? Isn't that amazing? Yeah,
it's
you
want
to wake up.
It's just
up,
a government plot. It's
you
want to
wake up your spouse? This is a great way to do it. Just put a cicada in the bed.
Sounds like a freaking plane.
But when you're, it's almost like a pond sound, but you hear it most. I think you mostly hear it on a really hot, hazy, hot, humid day in August.
All right. Well, when you hear them in your yard this summer, make sure you call me in.
Cicadas, northeast. Let's see what comes up here. I'm just looking it up. Northeast.
That's a big bug. It's a big insect.
It is a large insect. And okay, there are at least 15 cycles or broods of periodical cicadas, some of which emerge every 17 years. So you're right. It does come out. The big broods come out. In periods, while others emerge every 13 years. Different broods of cicadas emerge in different parts of the eastern half of the U.S. in different years. That's the problem. You get different broods, and for the most part,
you'll have them consistently every year, but
I believe
they could be
so.
A different brand.
And this is what it says. Why do I hear cicadas every summer? And it says the rest of the species, the so-called annual cicadas, have unsynchronized development. So some individuals mature in every year. You'll hear them every summer.
Okay.
But these big, massive cicada birthings, if you will, or whatever. These only happen like every 13 or 17 years. Okay. Does that make any sense?
Yeah. So it's gonna be one of the big summers.
But you will hear it. I mean, you hear that sound, and it's just one of the sounds of summer. But there are some areas where it's so loud. If you're focusing on it, it'll distract you. It'll cause you big problems. Terrible story. I'm looking that bad.
Yeah. I know, just with Willie coming
I'll
up.
I'll be fine. all right, Willie's coming up. Willie Waffle's coming up in a second. Do you call him? Or does he call us? Have him call my number. You have no way to do that, do you? I just wanted to get this story in that was in the Post Standard. That a New York teacher at the Kendall Elementary School, which is out maybe Rochester area, about 30 miles northwest of Rochester. She was pregnant. She texted her husband, and then she dropped, collapsed, and died.
Oh, my God.
Courtney Fannin, who had taught at the Kendall Elementary School since 2018, was found unresponsive in her classroom March 8th. She had collapsed moments after she sent a text message to her husband. She was pregnant. Later that evening, Courtney and her unborn daughter, whom the couple had intended to name Hadley J., passed away despite life-saving efforts by medical staff at the school. At this point, they don't know nothing suspicious, but they don't know.
So were students in?
No.
Oh, my God.
You know, it was probably a break. We mentioned Mannion. Mannion has received the Working Families Party endorsement for the 22nd.
Endorsement
for the 22nd Congressional District. I know we were just kind of talking about that. There was an announcement yesterday that Spaghetti Joe's, there's a story up on our website. Spaghetti Joe's, Politary Joe's, is for sale again. Did you see that?
Is it Politary Joe's?
I believe it's Politary Joe's, yeah.
Okay. I want to make sure, because there's a number of Joe's, actually.
Well, there's the new Joe's. There's the new Joe's that just opened up maybe a few years back after COVID. And, you know, that place does very well. But after nearly 115 years of home cooking on the corner of J Street and Pelletary Avenue, Pelletary Joe's, known as Joe's Restaurant.
Don't ask for bread or butter.
And don't ask for butter, is up for sale.
Wow.
Uh-huh. All right, let me break, and we'll come back. Willie Waffle will get to the streaming, the movies you can check out this weekend. All of those things as part of your... Or not part. Maybe you want to ignore the parade celebration and the St. Patrick's celebration. But I'm just simply saying, want to see a movie? There may be some options for you. Willie Waffle coming up in a few minutes. He also has a really cool streaming program to check out as well. We'll get to it all coming up at WIBX.
At New York Sash.
Scott and Jill here again, inviting you to visit our Idea and Design Center showroom at 349 Oriskany Boulevard in Whitesboro. It's a great chance for you to not just see, but also touch and feel all of our windows and doors, siding and bath products.
Most companies are going to force you to make a major, important remodeling decision by looking at itty-bitty, teeny-weeny photos on a website or in a catalog.
But this is your home, for crying out loud. It's important to get it right. So come in and take a look with your eyes and with your hands.
Heck, you can even smell it if you want.
Drop by our showroom from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. or Saturdays from 9 to 1 at 349 Oriskany Boulevard in Whitesboro.
Call New York Sash now and get 15% off windows, doors, or bathrooms, or online at newyorksash.com. That's newyorksash.com.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential. But finding those people can be a major hassle, unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. And right now you can try it for free at ziprecruiter.com/free. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. And the results speak for themselves. Four out of five employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
For over 30 years, the Good News Center has been committed to building relationships. Better relationships for marriage, better family relationships, a better relationship with God, and a better relationship with yourself. The free programs we offer are designed to support you and your needs. If you find yourself struggling with the loss of a loved one, Grief Survivors is here to help guide you through this difficult time. The program is mentored by your peers who understand what you are feeling, and the facilitator will provide you with the tools necessary to move through the grieving process. Grief Survivors has helped many during this time of need. Visit our website, thegoodnewscenter.org, to find out about all of our programs, including Grief Survivors, or call us at 315-735-6210. These programs are free, confidential, and open to all. The Good News Center, building relationships for over 30 years.
Make the most of your tax refund and shop the Carl's Wholesale Furniture Warehouse Tax Refund Sale. In stock, in style, and all on sale. Only at Carl's and the New Hartford Shopping Center.
Hello, I'd like to vote for president, governor, and anything that will take money away from our parks and libraries.
Go vote now. It'll make you feel big and strong.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. The Keeler Show.
Well, good Friday morning. And another beautiful day yesterday. And actually, today won't be that bad. The rain subsiding, and it'll be cooler, though. And then tomorrow, 50 degrees, before things do cool off Sunday, Monday, Tuesday next week. You know what? I'm hearing a lot of people opening their pools.
Early,
always
huh?
important to open a pool before it gets warm, and they're worried about warm days because those warm days will cause algae in the pool.
Blue-green algae.
A lot of people opening early this year. Because you know what? I'll bet we have a couple 75-degree days coming up, maybe even in March or April. I think you'll be shocked by it.
I hope so.
Here's the man with the plan, Willie Waffle, online right now. Willie, good morning.
Hey, how's it going today?
Good. Good Friday. Do you partake in any of the Binghamton St. Patrick's Day festivities?
Oh, dear Lord, no. I can't get in the middle of that mess, man.
Smart.
I don't know how familiar you are with the Binghamton St. Patrick's Day parade, which took place a couple weeks ago.
Oh, it did. It is, okay.
Oh, yeah. It is everything I hate about society. I'm sorry. I just, you know, there's too many people. They allow drinking on the streets openly.
Oh,
so
yeah,
like
it's wild.
Everybody's drunk off their you-know-what. It has nothing to do with celebrating St. Patrick's Day, and that's the part that upsets me.
Yeah, but it's almost offensive to the Irish people, you know?
Like, oh, okay.
Oh, look
let's
at
just
that.
Have
we're just a bunch
fun.
Of drunks.
All right, so in theaters, what do you have?
Well, you know, we've got Arthur the King, Marky Mark Wahlberg making just a formulaic sports movie, and wouldn't you know it, it works. You know, here he is on this endurance team. You know, they race across the entire country, you know, trying to do it, like, in a certain amount of time. And, well, you know, he's had his failures. He's had problems in the past. Nobody wants to be on his team, but he finally gets a bunch of underdogs. And one night, they kind of run into this stray dog, and they feed it. And now he's racing with them, too. Mm. And it's all about the dog helping them and them helping the dog and good feelings all around.
What do you give it?
You know, I got to tell you, it actually works. I'm giving it 3 waffles.
Wow.
I think, you know, listen, you're cheering for the dog, which is just cute as all the dickens, right? You know, Marky Mark Wahlberg knows, hey, the dog's the star of the movie, so he's not overdoing it. He's going with the flow. He picks his moments to show you his pain inside. I you know what? Even though you can predict everything that's going to happen in this movie, it makes you feel good, and
all
that's
right.
What counts.
All right. And then everybody's always looking for a series to watch, a mini series of some sort. Peacock has Apples Never Fall. What do you think?
I am totally into this. It's a 7-episode miniseries. Annette Bening and Sam Neill play this married couple down in West Palm Beach, Florida. They've just retired from running their world-famous tennis academy. And, well, the family's a mess. They don't all get along. There's all sorts of tensions, all sorts of problems. And then one day, Annette Bening goes missing, and all the adult kids are convinced Dad did it. Mm. And so the whole series is, what really happened? Where's Annette Bening? And they lay out all sorts of other suspects. And you see all the horrible things that have been going on in this family. And it's just, they're spilling the tea left and right, and I'm there licking it up, baby. I'm at like 3.5 waffles.
Wow. Apples
never
fall.
All
right. In theaters.
Peacock. So you have
Peacock
Apples.
Series.
Apples, yep. Never Fall, 7 episodes. And then Arthur the King in theaters, 2 things worth seeing. Maybe just getting into the theater and getting away. Nothing wrong with that. So, all right, good stuff there, Willie. I hope you enjoy your non-St. Patrick's Day celebration weekend.
I'm going to enjoy the St. Patrick's Day celebration because all the drunks are done with the parade from a couple
weeks
ago.
That's right. You're
going
to enjoy the way it's supposed to be. All right, man, enjoy
That's
the
right.
weekend. We'll do it next week.
Thanks. All right, see
Thanks
you later.
So much.
Dominic Street in Rome. In stock models, on sale now, and it's the lowest prices of the season. Saltwater hot tubs sold by Hot Spring Spas, the number one manufacturer of hot tubs nationwide. You get instant cash rebates or 0% financing so you can start your wellness journey today. Liverpool Pool and Spa, 1501 East Dominic Street, Rome, or liverpoolpoolandspa.com.
Ariskin & Garage would like to thank our customers for once again voting us the best destination for tires in the Utica area. Huge selection, great prices on name brand tires, and our service will crush the internet retailers and chain stores. Take it away, monster truck guy.
For brakes, tires, funny noises, warning lights, or any auto repair needs, come and experience prompt and courteous service at Ariskin & Garage. Online at OGTires.com. Come on, say it with me and make that noise. OGTires.com.
My wife and I both, we ended up mildly sick for a few months, and the nasal congestion was probably the worst part. I had like a post-nasal drip, just super congested all the time. We were taking everything we possibly could, but nothing really worked.
Kyrie was miserable until a friend recommended Navage. Navage offers immediate drug-free congestion relief, flushing your nasal passages with refreshing saline and sucking out mucus, germs, and other airborne irritants. Don't live in misery this cold season. Use Navage so you can breathe easier, sleep better, and feel your best right away.
The biggest thing Navage has done has completely cleaned out my nasal passages. It was from the first use I was able to just clear out anything that was stopping me from breathing correctly. Navage helps me clear the way, literally clear the way, for me to operate better in the rest of my life.
Experience the Navage difference yourself. Navage is available at Navage.com or at Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, and Rite Aid. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E.
Fraudulent tax returns due identity theft increased by 30% in 2023. If you're in a bind this tax season, LifeLock can help. Their U.S.-based restoration specialists are dedicated to helping solve identity theft issues, and all plans are backed by the $1 Million Protection Package, which means if you lose money because of identity theft, LifeLock will reimburse you up to the limits of your plan. Help protect your information with LifeLock. Go to LifeLock.com and save up to 25% your first year with my name, Clay, as your promo code.
Hey there, it's Andrew from WIBX. If you're facing excruciating pain, whether it be carpal tunnel, knee pain, back pain, whatever it is, there is a revolutionary technology that has arrived in Utica. Forget the injections, forget surgery. Try Revive Softwave Therapy on Genesee Street in Utica. This brand new treatment will help you. It's got a 90% success rate, and it's with Dr. Tim Delmedico. For more information, visit reviveutica.com.
From the Stanley Theater Studio, WIBX 950 Utica Rome, W295 DI Utica Rome, your news, talk, and sports leader, a Town Square Media Station.
Tornado death and destruction in Ohio.
I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News.
It's because we had this major system that developed across the Rockies, brought 4 feet of snow, and then it crashed into very warm, unstable air.
And Fox meteorologist Janice Dean says that spawned a lot of tornadoes, with Fox affiliates in Ohio reporting 4 to 6 deaths in the destruction around Indian Lake, northwest of Columbus. Parts of Indiana got twisted apart, too.
I wish we had more information about the loss of life or significant injuries. There have been many, many significant injuries. But I don't know the number. I don't know where they are. I don't know what those injuries are. None of us do.
State Police Superintendent Doug Carter says the Winchester area east of Indianapolis has a lot of damage. Parts of Kentucky also hit with tornadoes.
You could actually, like, feel just the storm just hitting, and it was kind of terrifying.
He's in Milton. Now, sometime today, a judge in Georgia will rule on an attempt to get District Attorney Fani Willis removed from the Trump election interference case over a romantic relationship with a special prosecutor that Fani Willis hired for the case. The defense says it's a conflict of interest. The day after, a federal judge in Florida rejected one of two Trump motions in the former president's attempt to get the classified documents criminal case dismissed. Judge Eileen Cannon did not rule on the other yet.
Throughout the 4 hours in court, there was some real skepticism on the part of this judge. She said dismissing this case might be premature. She also said it might be better left to a jury.
Fox's Steve Harrigan. They're voting in Russia in a three-day presidential election expected to be another easy win for Vladimir Putin.
There are three other names on the ballot paper, but to illustrate the level of competition, when asked why he should be president instead of Vladimir Putin, one rival candidate told the BBC, "That's not for me to say," and opted to praise the president instead.
Fox's Jonathan Savage. Iran-backed Houthi militants have struck again from Yemen, hitting another ship in the Red Sea today with a missile, damaging the tanker, but the crew is said to be safe. America's listening to Fox News.
Hi, I'm Martha Stewart. Every year, more than 4 million pets enter shelters here in the United States. My friends at American Humane have been helping animals since 1877. The goal is to ensure that pets have a safe shelter, especially during natural disasters. Adopting a shelter pet allows shelters to help more animals awaiting care. Please consider adopting today and take some time to learn more about American Humane's other work at AmericanHumane.org.
Pure Talk believes in American values and that free should mean exactly that, free. Well, switch to Pure Talk today and you'll get a free Samsung 5G smartphone. Now, qualifying plans start at just $35 a month for unlimited talk, text, 15 gigs of data, and, of course, mobile hotspot. Just dial #250, say the keyword Pure Talk, claim your eligibility for your free brand new Samsung 5G smartphone. Start saving on wireless today and switch to my cell phone company, Pure Talk.
Guilty. That's the verdict in Michigan. Holding a school shooter's father criminally responsible, just like his mother.
An Oakland County jury convicting James Crumbly on all four counts.
Guilty of involuntary manslaughter as to Tate Near.
The 47-year-old held accountable for failing to prevent his son, Ethan, from fatally shooting four of his classmates at Oxford High School in 2021, with prosecutors arguing he failed to secure the gun that was used and ignored signs the then 15-year-old was struggling with mental health. A sentencing hearing set for April 9th. His wife, Jennifer Crumbly, was convicted last month on the same charges. Ethan Crumbly was sentenced to life in prison without parole. He was charged as an adult and pleaded guilty to 24 charges, including first-degree murder and terrorism. Kristen Goodwin, Fox News.
There was a shooting on a subway train in New York City yesterday afternoon, scaring passengers. Police say two men got into a fight in Brooklyn, and then during their struggle, one pulled out a gun. The other took that gun and shot the man with it. The 36-year-old who was shot is in critical condition. The other is in custody. In Connecticut, a nightmare.
A baby has died in East Hartford after getting attacked by a dog while he was on a trampoline with his mother. Police say he had been bitten several times by what they describe as a mixed breed dog. The baby was rushed to a hospital, but police say the valued efforts of medical professionals were not enough to save him. Two dogs have been removed from the home. The incident remains under investigation. Tom Rigotti, Fox News.
On Wall Street, stock futures are rising. The day after selling dragged the Dow down 137 points. The top team in the NBA is the first to clinch a playoff spot with still a month to go in the regular season. Boston beat Phoenix 127-112 to clinch. The Celtics now a league best 52-14. In golf's Players Championship, Rory McIlroy tops the leaderboard after round one, tied with Xander Schauffele and Wyndham Clark at 7 under par. I'm Dave Anthony. This is Fox News.
Good morning, WIBX 950 News Time at 7:05. I'm Andrew Dominio. We got some rain, 46 degrees. Your full weather forecast is coming up. This update brought to you by the new Destination Kia of Utica on Commercial Drive in Yorkville. There is a travel advisory to let you know about. There has been an injury crash, according to the New York State Thruway Authority, in the right lane of I-90 between is eastbound between exit 33 and 32. That's between Westmoreland and Utica. Again, that is eastbound, right lane blocked, left lane is open. So do beware that if you're traveling there, it may take you a little longer this morning on your commute. With a lot of people heading out to celebrate St. Patrick's Day, police statewide are going to be keeping a very close eye out for drunk drivers. Travelers can expect to see increased patrols on the roads that will begin today and run through Sunday. Folks who are planning to drink alcoholic beverages are urged to make sure they have a safe ride home. Anyone who sees suspicious or dangerous activity while they're driving should dial 911. Starting today, Destiny USA is going to start offering free glasses people can use to view the upcoming solar eclipse. All anyone has to do is sign up to become part of the mall's mailing list, and once that is completed, they'll be eligible to get two pairs of glasses on a first-come, first-served basis. These glasses will be located at the guest services desk on the first level of the mall, below the carousel. The U.S. District Court at 10 Broad Street in Utica was filled with cheers, applause, and waving American flags as 52 individuals from 20 nations were sworn in as American citizens on Wednesday, March 14th. United States District Court Judge David Hurd presided over the ceremony, who welcomed all of the new citizens and their loved ones and encouraged them to celebrate the accomplishment. New Hartford Legion Post 1376 delivered the presentation of colors, and Jawad Rashid, Chief Accountability Officer for the Syracuse Police Department, gave remarks. And the newly appointed New Orleans Police Chief says that rats have been eating marijuana that had been seized and stored in their evidence room. That's brought up questions about an effect on criminal cases. District Attorney Jason Williams said in a statement that it has not impacted convictions. He's set to tour the facility next week. Maybe it'll slow those rats down just a bit. It is 7:07. Your weather forecast is brought to you by the new Destination Kia of Utica on Commercial Drive in Yorkville.
Eyewitness News Chief Meteorologist Craig Flint in the WIBX Weather Center. Today, leftover shower early, then drier, breezy, cooler afternoon. Gradually clearing sky, a high near 50. Tonight, partly to mostly cloudy, a low of 36. And for parade day Saturday, mostly cloudy, dry for the parade, then some afternoon clearing, a high of 52. For more on your local forecast, tune to Eyewitness News at 6 on WTR. Meteorologist Craig Flint on WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM.
Right now, it is 46 degrees with some light rain. It's 7:08. Sports brought to you by IBEW NECA 43 local contractors. The Utica University men's Pioneers will take the ice at home tonight. Puck drops at 7 p.m. against Plymouth State University. The first round or quarterfinals round of the NCAA tournament here at the Adirondack Bank Center. Fear the Moose. Let's go, Utica. The Yankees were spanked by the Detroit Tigers 7-0 in Lakeland. Marcus Stroman got the start and allowed 5 runs, 4 of them earned on 7 hits over 4 and a third innings pitched. New York will look to snap their 3-game losing streak when they host the Pirates tonight in Tampa at George Steinbrenner Field. The Mets and Cardinals play to a scoreless tie in Jupiter. Jose Buto started the game for the Mets and struck out 3 batters while allowing 2 hits over 4 innings pitched. New York will host the Washington Nationals tonight in Port St. Lucie. Bill mentioned it earlier, St. John's opened its postseason with a blowout win at Madison Square Garden. The Red Storm throttled Seton Hall 91-72 in the quarterfinals of the Big East Tournament. St. John's is one step away from the finals. They have to take on top-seeded UConn in tonight's semifinal round. Meanwhile, some shakeups continue at the NFL level. The Chicago Bears are making a major splash in the trade market. The team acquired six-time Pro Bowl wide receiver Keenan Allen
from the Los Angeles Chargers on Thursday. The Bears sent back a fourth-round pick in this year's NFL draft to complete the trade. Allen set a career high in receptions with 108 in 2023. He also had 1,243 receiving yards and 7 touchdowns while appearing in 13 games. Meanwhile, the Commanders are trading away their starting quarterback from last season. Washington is sending quarterback Sam Howell a fourth-round pick and a sixth-rounder to Seattle in exchange for a third-round pick and fifth-rounder in this year's draft. Howell is expected to be the top backup behind starting quarterback Geno Smith next season. And finally, Christopher Bell hopes to become the first driver to win multiple races this season as the NASCAR Cup Series rolls into Bristol, Tennessee for the Food City 500 on Sunday afternoon. The driver of the number 20 car took home the checkered flag in the Shriners Children's 500 at Phoenix Raceway last weekend. Bell is 12th in the Cup Series standings, while Ryan Blaney, Kyle Larson, Martin Truex Jr., William Byron, and Tyler Reddick make up the top five. The soft wave tissue regeneration technology is revolutionary, and it's developed in Germany and has made its way to Genesee Street in Utica. 2709 Genesee Street, to be exact. It's Revive Softwave Therapy, and you can learn more about it at reviveutica.com. Reviveutica.com. This incredible machine has helped me dramatically, bringing my ankle and foot pain from an 8 down to 0, literally. And one of the big things they help is with neuropathy. So if you're battling that, you got the purple foot and maybe some pooling and draining and some blood in your foot there. I was talking to Dr. Nate the other day. He said after one treatment, a woman who had severe neuropathy and purple in her foot has already started to make a turnaround in their first treatment. This thing actually works. It's not a gimmick. It's FDA 510 cleared for activation of connective tissue, which means if you have bone-on-bone injuries, give it a try. Treatment of chronic diabetic foot ulcers, treatment of acute second-degree burns, pain reduction, and improved blood supply. That's exactly how this machine works. It uses high-speed sound waves to direct blood flow and stem cells to the body's impacted area, which promotes natural healing. So if you're sick of the pain pills that can make you sick, the injections that only last a certain amount of time, and these things only mask the pain. It doesn't actually help you to cure the problem. This will. Give Dr. Tim Delmedico and his team a call at 315-725-8427. That's 315-725-8427. Or again, at reviveutica.com and let the healing begin.
So I have a comment from Michael this morning. So I see the Michigan shooter's father has been found guilty. So my question is, what is the difference between him and parent or parents who have teenagers that have guns and are shooting people? The short answer is there is none. Mm. I don't know. This is I do think this opens a can of worms, which can be good and bad, but I guess
it's
you know,
an interesting point. It is a very interesting point.
It is, yeah. So now the mother and the father have both been found guilty. So you had to expect that that guilty verdict was probably coming. So, all right, we'll do Habika's free money question of the day coming up this morning, and we'll get to that in a few minutes. Got a good one today. We'll see where we're going in terms of money today. He's been flirting with disaster. I'm talking about Davey all week long. and we'll speak with, she's a New Hartford grad, and she's an author. She is releasing now her second published book, and we'll have a Barnes & Noble book signing coming up. Is that right?
That's tomorrow, yes.
Okay, it's tomorrow. So we'll chat with her coming up in a second, so stand by for that. It's Friday morning, day before the big parade on WIBX.
Help the Rome Rescue Mission provide the chance for a new beginning for a family in our area. Poverty and despair are not just big city problems. It is the Rome Rescue Mission's goal this Easter season to help 500 families. You can help a family of five this Easter with your generous support of $25. For $25, the Rome Rescue Mission will provide a family of five with a hot meal and give them a memorable Easter celebration. A feeling of safety, a feeling of knowing that someone cares. From there, a person can rebuild a life.
Through resurrection power comes freedom from the past and an unlimited future. Each person deserves a chance at a new beginning. Won't you help make that happen for 500 families this season? Please donate now at RomeMission.org. That's RomeMission.org. Rome Rescue Mission. A hand up, not a handout.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major.
It within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
This is a special alert to all Americans who own a vehicle with less than 200,000 miles with an auto warranty about to expire or with no warranty coverage at all. Due to a decline in the economy, CarShield is announcing a low-cost, month-to-month vehicle protection plan that is now available to the public to save any driver out-of-pocket expenses on future auto repairs. Call now to find out how you can pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. Yes, you heard that correctly. Pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. An open phone line has been established for all drivers to call for a free quick quote. Call 800-294-8831 now. Drivers who are covered will not have to pay for covered repairs again. This protection plan is at an all-time low. Additionally, drivers who activate this vehicle protection today will also receive free roadside assistance, free towing, and car rental options at no additional cost. Call us for your free quick quote today. 800-294-8831. That's 800-294-8831. What do you have to lose? Call 800-294-8831. Again, 800-294-8831.
All over America, business owners are thanking Swish Funding, the small business owner's friend.
Thanks to Swish Funding, I was able to secure the funds my business needed to expand, even with my less than perfect credit history. The process was quick and straightforward, and the funds were in my account within 24 hours. Swish Funding is a game changer.
Whether it's $25,000, $500,000, or even $5 million, Swish Funding's simple application process takes just minutes, with funding as soon as one business day. If you've been in business for 1 year and have monthly revenue of at least $25,000, you can get the funding you need with no collateral. Swish Funding is different than other lenders. We focus on your business cash flow, not your personal credit score. And we're ready to help your business or practice with funding for overhead, expansion, inventory, payroll, or just slow cash flow. Get the funding your business needs the easier, faster, better way. Go to swishfunding.com today. That's S-W-I-S-H funding.com. Swishfunding.com.
Hello, everyone in Central New York. This is Dave Letterman, your old TV pal. Remember me? I'm supposed to say something witty and funny here about Bill Keeler, but I've got nothing. Ever see a picture of this guy? That's a joke in itself. Anyhow, here's Keeler on WIBX.
This is Keeler on WIBX 950. Online at WIBX950.com.
Giving you a reason to drum over there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Because it's Friday.
All right. It's Friday morning. It's Friday morning. The parade is tomorrow. The step-off for the St. Patrick's Day Parade in Utica is 10 a.m. And there's a cool story up on our website at WIBX950.com that has dozens and dozens and dozens of great photos taken by Tom Laughlin, Jr.
Tom's the man.
And you check out this parade and you say, how are we not in the list of the, forget the 200 best parades, forget the 100, how are we not in the top 20?
I know.
It just blows my mind. Angelina Scriptor was only 18 years old when she published her first work, Roses and Thorns, 100 Poems for Life. After graduating high school with highest honors and the seal of biliteracy in Latin and English, it became her goal to continue working on books and following what was once seen as her childhood dream. Now she's 19. She's published her first novel, and she is on the line right now. Angelina, good morning. Oh, I got you over here. Hi, Angelina. Good morning.
Hi, good morning.
So you have a new book out. This is a novel. Talk about this one.
Yes. So I wrote Trees of Fate. It's a dystopian romance novel, which means it's kind of like a post-apocalyptic, the world has gone wrong, and then these kids are going to try to save it. And I published
it. Oh, so it's nonfiction. That's good. That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's a young adult novel as well. So
you're going to hold a book signing tomorrow over at Barnes & Noble.
Yes, that'll be from 1 to 3, but I might be lingering around the store a little bit longer than that.
Okay, fair enough.
So, Angelina, what inspired you to want to write? Is it something that at a very young age you were just inspired to do?
Yeah, so I've honestly wanted to become a writer since I was, as long as I can remember. The earliest record of me saying I wanted to go into writing was actually a home video. I was 3 years old.
Wow. I was 3 years old, and I said, I want to destroy my life and go into radio. 3 years old. It was amazing. It was amazing how I, not only did I know what I wanted to do, but I knew what it was going to do to me. That's the best.
That's dedication right there.
But you, on the other hand, have something special here. So the novel is entitled Trees of Fate.
Yes.
And you're residing here in the area, right?
Yes, I live in New Hartford.
Okay. And then what's next? I mean, this can't be the end.
You're probably already working on novel 2 and 3, right?
What's happening?
Yeah, so I've been planning to write a medieval fantasy trilogy for a while now. I've been working on it since I was around probably 14.
All right.
And I plan on polishing and publishing that as my next big project. And I also want to write some more poetry books.
Okay, very
so what's
cool.
Interesting about Angelina is, like many recent musicians that have kind of rose to fame and rose to popularity, doing it without record companies and doing it without any assistance there, mostly social media based. I think that's kind of what your story is, right? You own you're kind of run your own publishing company and such, right?
Yeah, it was shortly after I graduated that I learned on my own with the help from my mom how to start an LLC, and I ended up getting in contact with the Library of Congress and getting it confirmed as an official publishing company and firm. So
nice,
I run
nice.
This representing publishing company.
That's very cool.
Cut out the uppers. Straight profit. That's a smart way to do it.
And the middle people. All right, that is really – have you seen the – I guess it was on Apple TV – did you watch Dickinson?
I did not.
You should check that out. It's kind of interesting. It's a, it's modern meets classic. So it tells her story with a modern twist with modern music and also modern dialogue.
Dickinson was living in this era.
Kind of like that, but not really, because she's still living in that era. But they twist in with all sorts of fantasy and stuff like that. It's kind of interesting. We liked it. It's called Dickinson. And, of course, it's about Emily Dickinson. So all great stuff. So talk about the time again tomorrow over at Barnes & Noble.
Yes. So I will be at the New Hartford Barnes & Noble tomorrow doing a book signing and meet and greet. So even if people just want to come in and ask me some questions – that's totally an option. That'll be 1 to 3 tomorrow at the New Hartford Barnes & Noble.
Okay. All right. Very cool, Angelina. Angelina, thank you so much, and good luck out there.
Yes, thank you. If you guys don't mind, I'd love to give you guys some books, signed books, as a thank you for having me on the show today.
We would love that.
Appreciate that.
We would love that. So, and we'll get you back on again.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you.
Okay. Very cool, right?
Yeah, I mean, 19 years old already knows what she wants to do and published 2 works already. That's pretty incredible.
Again,
I can't imagine what I was doing at 19.
Again, that will be, Davey, somebody's trying to reach us, and they can call now. So the book signing is tomorrow at Barnes & Noble. So if you're not out there as part of the big, you know, St. Patrick's celebration, maybe that's where you want to stop. Pretty cool. Good for her starting her own publishing company.
Yeah, I mean, that's smart. It's just, like I said, it's just like a lot of these artists who became famous over COVID and, you know, because of the era of TikTok where they have fans now despite not having a record company. So yeah. They just have a following, and that's how they get their music out.
Toronto police are saying that people should stop trying to stop others from stealing their cars. Can you believe that's where we are now? So what they're saying is it's kind of like the shoplifting thing.
Right. Don't stop us.
So they'll tell employees, don't stop a shoplifter. Let him go. We'll get him. Yeah. Not really.
Don't worry.
We'll put him in jail. We know that's not happening. but what they don't want is somebody to get injured. And the same thing's going on with carjacking. So police in Toronto are saying, just let them steal your car. You have insurance. it's saying during a carjacking situation, leave your keys at the front door for easy access. You've got to be kidding me. You think we have it bad? What's going on in Canada? They're suggesting this to avoid any violent confrontations. Here's Toronto Police Service Constable Marco Riccardi talking about leaving your keys near the front door just in case someone wants to, you know, rip you off.
To prevent the possibility of being attacked in your home, leave your fobs at your front door. Because they're breaking into your home to steal your car. They don't want anything else. A lot of them that they're arresting have guns on them, and they're not toy guns. They're real guns. They're loaded.
This is the dumbest thing I have ever heard in my life. There's a thing going on in Canada right now where they're trying to pass a law on hate speech, and you could find yourself being put in jail for something that, you know, this kind of comes back to something very similar when we had the, what was the thing here in Utica where it was the online public shaming, you know. You have to.
Topics.
So right,
cyberbullying law.
Cyberbullying. And that law actually read that it was a crime if the person felt intimidated.
Yeah.
And felt
bullied. Harmony's big piece of legislation.
And what I'm saying is, I know some people that feel intimidated when they hear a noise in their house and it's all made up in their head. You got to be careful here, and Canada's going off the deep end.
Yeah.
So here's the constable saying, listen, leave the keys.
Let them steal
Leave your key fob right out there at the front door. So if they're going to come in, they just take the car. They don't come in and beat you up. This is unbelievable.
I have to tell you something.
Oh, by the way, banks, leave the bag of money right out by the front door.
Canada, you know, I've never been, but people say it's a beautiful place. Toronto.
Oh, Toronto's
awesome. My sister's
awesome.
Been there recently. But I was in a changing room in an outlet mall in Florida over the weekend, and I heard the other person talking to the employee about moving down there, and they were from Canada, and they're like, yeah, we couldn't take it anymore. We've moved down. And the lady's like, yeah, you're not the first person. There's a lot of people relocating just because it's like madness in Canada.
That's what Florida has kind of become, right? It's not just Canada. It's everybody that's unhappy with government in New York is moving to Florida and saying,
I've
escaped. I can't take it anymore. and I guess
they've got guns, eh?
But this is nutty.
Not toy ones.
You think our bail reform is a problem? What is going on here?
Just leave the cars unlocked, running.
Leave it right there for them to steal. It really is just unbelievable. All right, Andrew, 11 update coming up in just a second. We'll do Hobica's free money question of the day. I'm excited about that, Davey. And now here we go. This morning, Davey, Hobica's free money question of the day. Here comes the big question. The big question is, how much money will we take a shot at for Hobica's free money question of the day this morning?
I'm sticking to my guns, and I've got rejected all week, $100.
Well, I think it should be. It's Friday.
Okay.
And it is St. Patrick's Day.
300.
What?
Sticking to his guns.
He's sticking to his guns right up until he doesn't. It's
it's a toy gun, eh?
It's $300. $300. How much money this morning is on the line? How much money?
Three.
See if they confirm.
$300.
Yeah, it's confirmed. It's confirmed. Oh, smart my man. Lord. Oh, Micah. Ooh. All right, what caller number are you going to be looking for? Not yet, but you'll be looking for?
Caller number 5.
Fifth caller. So get ready for that. Don't do it now. And remember, we have a new number. You can see it up on our YouTube feed. It's right up there posted in clear daylight. 315-723-3824. Coming up in a few minutes, we'll give you a chance to call in. And Andrew has news coming up in just a second. Let me tell you, it's Steep Pawnee Mazda. Their new year, new Mazda sales event is back, and it's bigger and better than ever. Drive a new 2024 Mazda CX-30 select sport model for only $297 a month on a 36-month lease. Or save with low APR financing, 0.9%, 1.9%, 2.9% on select award-winning new 2024 Mazdas. I see more Mazdas on the road now. It is a hot brand, a hot vehicle. The CX-90, love it. And it's highly rated when you look at Consumer Reports. It's one of the top ones up there for SUVs. Let's make your deal on a new Mazda, says Ricky Z., where it's always easy to do business. Steep Pawnee Mazda, Commercial Drive in Yorkville.
Commercial mowers are built tough to work hard. Whether you need a fleet of mowers or you're a one-man show, you don't have time for downtime. Hustler mowers are over-engineered, overbuilt, and tested well beyond what's required. With the most complete lineup in the industry, including exclusives like a 104-inch Super 104, an 80-inch stand-on, and industry-leading warranties, Hustler mowers are ready to handle what you throw at them. Find your next Hustler at Warner Sales and Service, located just off Route 365 between Rome and Verona.
Cashback is not available on gas in New Jersey and Wisconsin.
Hey, good morning. You're heading to the airport, right?
Yep, thanks for checking. I like the car. How long have you been a rideshare driver?
About 3 years now. I really enjoy it.
Isn't it hard to make money these days with the price of gas being so high?
Not for me. I use Upside, the free app that gives you cash back for every gallon of gas you buy.
Wait a minute. Are you saying you actually get real money back when you get gas with the Upside app?
Yep, I get real cash back every time I get gas.
Does that actually add up to anything?
I'll make around $200 to $300.
Wow, that's serious extra cash. I'm downloading the Upside app now.
Download the free Upside app now to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code GEAR for an extra 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. You can cash out anytime right to your bank account, PayPal, or a gift card for Amazon and other brands. Just download the free Upside app and use promo code GEAR for a 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. That's code GEAR.
A flex at bed is where each head goes up and down independently, but it's still one solid mattress, and Mattress Express has the largest selection in New York State. Right now, get a queen flex head bed with adjustable base and sheets for only $14.99. Locations at MattressExpressNY.com.
Fraudulent tax returns due identity theft increased by 30% in 2023. If you're in a bind this tax season, LifeLock can help. They're U.S.-based restoration specialists are dedicated to helping solve identity theft issues, and all plans are backed by the $1 Million Protection Package, which means if you lose money because of identity theft, LifeLock will reimburse you up to the limits of your plan. Help protect your information with LifeLock. Go to LifeLock.com and save up to 25% your first year with my name, Clay, as your promo code.
Pizza's here.
Oh, great. I'd love some, but I'm worried about my stomach issues.
If you're worried about having diarrhea, gas, bloating, stomach pain, or loose, oily stools, it may not just be stomach issues. It could be a condition called exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, or EPI. With EPI, the pancreas doesn't release enough enzymes to break down food, but EPI is manageable. Use the symptom checker on IdentifyEPI.com and talk to your doctor. That's IdentifyEPI.com. Sponsored by AbbVie.
Hey, business owners, are you looking for a fast, easy way to get the cash you need to keep your business growing strong? I'm talking to Joel Bess, president of Swish Funding, and he says he has the perfect solution. Joel, what makes Swish Funding different?
Thanks, Mike. To start, at Swish Funding, we focus on your business revenue, not your personal credit score. And we're ready to help businesses with funding for overhead, expansion, inventory, payroll, or even slow cash flow. Next, whether you need $5,000, $500,000, or even $5 million, our process is quick, straightforward, and takes just minutes with funding available in less than 24 hours.
That sounds like a winning plan for any business. What does it take to qualify?
If you've been in business for over 1 year and have a monthly revenue of at least $25,000, you can get funding you need the same day.
Swish Funding really is different. Joel, what's the first step?
It's easy. You just go to swishfunding.com. That's S-W-I-S-H funding.com. Swishfunding.com.
Make the most of your tax refund and shop the Carl's Wholesale Furniture Warehouse Tax Refund Sale. In stock, in style, and all on sale. Only at Carl's and the New Hartford Shopping Center.
Good morning. WIBX 950 News Time, 735. I'm Andrew Dermenio. We have some light precipitation, cloudy skies, and we're at 45 degrees. Your full weather forecast is coming up. Just to make you aware, if you're traveling on the New York State Thruway between exits 33 and 32 eastbound, there has been an injury crash, and the left lane is open, but the right lane remains blocked. So if you're traveling east from Westmoreland to Utica, be sure to give yourself a little extra time as there is a lane blockage due to a injury-related crash. With a number of people out celebrating St. Patrick's Day this weekend, police statewide are going to be keeping a very close eye out for drunk drivers. Travelers can expect to see increased patrols on the roads that will begin today and run through Sunday. Folks who are planning to drink alcoholic beverages are urged to make sure they have a safe ride home. Anyone who sees suspicious or dangerous activity while driving should dial 911. New Hartford police have made an arrest. They say he was found with several stolen credit cards. 42-year-old Jermaine Cole was charged by police with several felonies, according to the New Hartford Police Chief Ron Fontaine. Police say Cole allegedly had a stolen victim's purse from a local establishment in the town of New Hartford and then used the victim's credit cards unlawfully at four smoke shops throughout Utica and the town of New Hartford. Cole was charged with several felonies, including grand larceny in the fourth degree, identity theft in the second degree, and criminal possession of stolen property in the fourth degree. He was given an appearance ticket and is due back in town of New Hartford Criminal Court at a later date. The United States District Court at 10 Broad Street in Utica was filled with cheers, applause, and waving of American flags as 52 individuals from 20 nations were sworn in as American citizens Wednesday. United States District Court Judge David Hurd presided over the ceremony, who welcomed all of the new citizens and their loved ones and encouraged them to celebrate the accomplishment. New Hartford Legion Post 1376 delivered the presentation of colors, and Jawad Rashid, Chief Accountability Officer for the Syracuse Police Department, gave remarks. And the Pittsburgh Penguins say a shipment of bobbleheads was stolen after it arrived in California. The shipment was carrying
All right, Davey, tell him.
Help me out.
Is it Yamir Yager?
Yeah, thank you.
Yamir Yager. That's what I was going to
say. Yamir Yager.
That's what I was going to say.
Whatever his bobblehead was.
Were stolen.
Yeah.
That's terrible.
You got to read ahead. They were to be given away to fans at their game against the San Jose Sharks tonight. The team said the bobbleheads will now be given out at a later date. The Penguins said the investigation is ongoing. You know, hockey names are probably the hardest to pronounce in major sports.
And you know my rule over that. Just gloss right over.
Well, Yamir Yager and Mario Lemieux were famous for being on the Penguins when they won all the Stanley Cups back in the 90s. Right. It was Yager and Lemieux. Okay. Yager and Lemieux.
I do believe it is Yaramir.
Lemieux and Yager. Yeah. Okay.
And if you're celebrating St. Patrick's Day, have an Irish lager.
We have a forecast for you to check out.
Yes, it's brought to you by the new Destination Kia of Utica on Commercial Drive in Yorkville.
Eyewitness News Chief Meteorologist Craig Flint in the WIBX Weather Center. Today, leftover shower early, then drier, breezy, cooler afternoon. Gradually clearing sky, a high near 50. Tonight, partly to mostly cloudy, a low of 36. And for parade day Saturday, mostly cloudy, dry for the parade, then some afternoon clearing, a high of 52. For more on your local forecast, tune to Eyewitness News at 6 on WTR. Meteorologist Craig Flint on WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM.
45 degrees under cloudy skies at 7:40.
All right, let's do Hobica's free money question of the day. A great question today. Davey has already said we're talking about $300. And you're looking for caller number?
Five.
Right now, 315-723-3824 is the number. 315, special number, folks, as we're broadcasting remotely from Studio B, as in basement. 315-723-3824, and we'll do it next on WIBX.
Worked hard for it. At Mattress Express, we're not only going to pay the sales tax for you, but qualified customers get zero down and up to 5 years interest-free on select luxury king and queen sets like the Smart Bed by Instant Comfort, Posh and Lavish, and more.
Did you find the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow?
No, but I found something even better. Affordable all-wheel drive SUVs for our customers.
During the Pot of Gold sales event, get no money down leases on all-wheel drive SUVs.
Like a brand new 2024 Kia Seltos LX all-wheel drive SUV for just $398 per month for 36 months.
And that's with zero down, zero due at inception, even sales tax included.
Plus, with 34 miles per gallon highway, you'll save gold on gas, too.
That's just one example of the deals on over 400 new Kias.
Now that's cookie!
So go cookie for Kia at the all-new Destination Kia of Utica. Puppies and babies not included.
2024 Kia Seltos LX AWD, stock number 24E. 0387 MSRP 26300 36 months 30,000 mile lease 20 cents per mile over $0 due at inception $0 security deposit 8.75% sales tax and $650 acquisition fee included in payment structure $400 disposition fee 720 plus FICO score offer expires 4/1/24.
Do you have over $10,000 in credit card debt? If you're feeling the financial impact with unprecedented economic challenges, DebtBlue is here for you. With DebtBlue's success guarantee, you pay nothing unless your debt is reduced or completely resolved.
I'm just living sky high right now. I'm very thankful for it, and the team at DebtBlue are phenomenal. They're able to work with you. They're great.
Call for your free debt resolution information now. 800-200-6895. 800-200-6895.
Hello, I'd like to vote for president, governor, and anything that will take money away from our parks and libraries.
Go vote now. It'll make you feel big and strong.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM, The Keeler Show.
Good morning, day before, the night before. St. Patrick's Day. That's Sunday, and the parade day is tomorrow. Tip-off or step-off of the parade is 10 a.m. Check it out. On the line right now, ready to take a shot at Hobica's free money question of the day, is Bob in Whitesboro. Hello, Bob. Hello.
Hey, Bill. How's it going?
Good. How you doing? You ready to go on this one?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right. It's from the category, Who Said It? Who Said It? And you'll have, as you know, 7 seconds to answer here from the category, Who Said It? Here we go. Oklahoma's favorite son said, I'm not a member of an organized political party. I'm a Democrat. Who said it? Ready, go.
Kennedy.
Did Kennedy say, I'm not a member of an organized political party, I'm a Democrat? And the answer is a buzzer on that one. Actually,
it's
was
the brother of Roy Rogers, who's got the throughway stop.
The key to this was Oklahoma's favorite son. Oklahoma's favorite son was Will Rogers, who once said, things aren't the way they used to be. You know, things aren't the way they used to be, and they probably never were. I love that line. Anyway, that's a funny line about Democrats, about political parties. I am not a member of an organized political party. I'm a Democrat. Of course, the answer you gave was wrong. We're going to give you the all-in-one food and fun card, all right? It's a $25 gift card, good at Comets games, Pioneers games, Aquavino, Babes, 72, the Taylor and the Cook, and the list goes on. So stand by. We're going to give it to Davey. He's going to hook you up, okay?
All right. Thanks, guys.
All right, Bob. Enjoy the weekend, too. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You know how you land on a quote and you're like, wow, that is one of my favorite quotes because it's so true.
We 100%.
We oftentimes are like, you know, remember back in the old days when things weren't like this? You usually find out
they weren't so great either.
They weren't so great either, yeah. And you hear a lot of it about kids. Although I do have to say, sometimes these kids are nuts today.
You think?
But maybe they were nuts back then, too.
But they were in a different form and fashion, right?
I remember things, when you'd look at something and you'd be like, wow, can't believe that doesn't happen anymore.
Wow, I can't believe he hit that baseball into that window and broke his neighbor's window. I mean, what a reckless, crazy kid.
Although, you know, we do have young kids out there shooting up people. That is definitely a problem.
Right.
Jake Paul should start drafting his last will and testament. If he hasn't already done so, Jake should start getting his affairs in order. Last week it was announced that Paul would be climbing into the ring to take on the former heavyweight champion of the world, Iron Mike Tyson. Since then, Tyson has released a video of day one of his training, and I got to tell you, I realize he is 57 years old, talking about Tyson.
Wow.
But Andrew, I'm here to tell you, Tyson looks good.
A lot better than me, and I'll tell you, I wouldn't want to get in the ring with him.
Experts that are watching are saying... Jake Paul, who is a YouTube star gone professional boxer?
Yeah, he's an influencer, and then I think he also doing MMA at one point, too?
Yeah, his brother is wrestling in the WWE, Logan Paul.
Okay, well, now he's going to be fighting Mike Tyson, day one of his training. People are worried for Jake. Tyson captioned the video, "It's day one, the fun has just begun," as he furiously works out.
So this is airing...
Looking considerably younger than his 57 years. The fight, some say, if that's what you want to call it, will air live on Netflix on July 20th, but I believe that's going to end up somehow being a pay-per-view. On Netflix, you can, I guess, using Netflix.
There's no, like, an additional charge option.
I don't know how they're going to do this.
It's very interesting. It's probably... Netflix is probably paying them both a ton of money to have it on their platform.
I'll bet. Yeah.
as they said in the Hangover movie when Alan got punched, he still got it. Tyson will give, as long as he doesn't bite his ear off, he'll be fine.
As long as he doesn't.
I broke my back. It's broken. Spinal.
So Donna asking, will you guys be in the parade tomorrow? We will not be, along with everything else. We do not have a van right now, which is being, we're waiting
renovated.
On a new van. So we have no vehicle. However, there will be stations from Town Square that will be in the parade tomorrow in Utica. The skin disease made famous in what publication? Leprosy, what publication? Yes, the Bible, is still with us, believe it or not. Leprosy is making a comeback in the United States. The number of cases in the U.S. is on the rise. It's beginning to occur regularly within parts of the southeastern United States. Most recently, Florida has seen a heightened incidence of leprosy, accounting for many of the newly diagnosed cases in the U.S. Traditional risk factors include zoonotic exposure, transmission between animals and humans, and having Andrew's itching already.
Yeah, I don't know. All of a sudden, I got this itch.
And having recently lived in leprosy-endemic countries, Brazil, India, and Indonesia have each reported more than 10,000 new cases since 2019, according to the World Health Organization. More than a dozen countries have reported between 1,000 and 10,000 new cases over the same time period. Armadillos are known transmitters of the disease. So if you see an armadillo, don't go hugging up to it.
What would Jesus do?
Or eating armadillo meat, while they say it's not a clear cause of leprosy, I'd say I'd be careful. Capturing and raising armadillos, along with preparing their meat, are risk factors. The good news, leprosy is not only preventable but treatable today with vaccines being developed as we speak, and the disease, once detected, can be readily treated. Although years ago, years and years and years ago, 2000, they wrapped a towel around you, loincloth or whatever around
you. Yeah, or they'd throw you in
your
a
head.
Pit and tell you that you're on your own. Stay away.
I want to say one more thing before we get into break, and I'd love if you have an opinion on this. 315-723-3824. I yesterday heard about it once again from someone who is an anti-vaxxer.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, I'm telling you, so-and-so died because of the vaccine. And I'm saying, do you have any, I hate to be the anti-Aaron Rodgers here, or the anti-Robert F. Kennedy, Robert Kennedy Jr., but the, do you, it's easy for someone to say, do you have evidence that it didn't? Well, yeah, millions and millions of people have taken the vaccine, mm-hmm. And millions of those people are still alive.
Well, they haven't died yet.
They haven't died yet. Well, it's coming. The problem is, though, I want to do a right back at you, which is what I did yesterday. I said, the answer when you say there's no evidence that it doesn't, I said, the answer, there is evidence that it doesn't. But you don't want to hear that. I would like, though, to go right back at you. Please give me the evidence that shows that the vaccine is killing people or the vaccine is causing whatever. There is zero evidence of that. You may have anecdotal. You actually have a story locally where there's a candidate who is, and it's not saying the vaccine, but you remember this story from yesterday?
No, but this was not anything vaccine related. This was the Whitesboro flooding issue.
But it's also conspiratorial. It's crazy. So the only thing I would say is I find that many of the people who say I would not take that vaccine, it's new science. That's not true. The vaccine was developed so quickly because we used old science, science that's been around for years and years. That very same, and the progress that we made over the course of the last, 5 years, is being used to help develop possible treatments for cancer. That's true. But what amazes me is the person that says, I'm not taking, you're not putting that in my body. Meanwhile, you want to talk about new science? Ozempic. They're on Ozempic. They're popping pills left and right for different things.
Shooting up.
And why is that okay? Why are you okay putting that into your body? I mean,
you're going to lose weight, Bill.
Okay. All right. I'm just saying.
You're going to lose weight.
I'm just saying, please show me the evidence, not from Facebook, where this is killing people. It's not. Please don't go down that rabbit hole. All right. Speaking of rabbit holes, there is a candidate out there.
Yeah, so.
And maybe Jake will call in.
Jacob Morgan.
Our phone number is 315-723-3824.
I got to remember who the Facebook page was. But
so
there was
just roll with it.
Jacob Morgan is a candidate for trustee in the village of Whitesboro.
He ran Mike Hennessy's campaign and has called the program several times. Oftentimes we'll call when Tony Pacini is on.
Yes, and he'll refute things that we talk about. And, he's very passionate, to say the least. But he, there was video that another, I think, I don't know if somebody on the board of trustees had released. But basically, he had shown video that he was going around to voters, and it was caught on a Ring or doorbell camera that suggested, that Jacob Morgan suggested, that the flooding in Whitesboro was the reason for his child's autism.
Mm.
I watched the video. It's kind of a roundabout way of him saying it. I've got to figure out who the person was.
So I can't imagine. The only thing I will say, and I don't know what kind of flooding that he had, but I can't imagine. One of the things they will tell you is when there is flooding, I wouldn't know anything about that to dispute it or say. I mean, maybe a doctor told him that's maybe one of the causes. But one of the problems you have with flooding is you're bringing in. The sewers become overflowing.
All sorts of stuff.
All the, there's water coming in from the, from the ground. There's landfill. There's, all sorts of probably poisons. You don't want to be, I would think that flooding water is not something that you want to be drinking or wading around in.
Right.
So,
and if your particular home is in that impacted area, you know, let's say your backyard floods or something like that, it could remain in the
But
the
again,
grass.
I don't know how you would have proof.
I sent you the link to the video if maybe you want to
okay.
get into
Well, I mean, my focus is really on the COVID vaccine. And then somebody said, well, look, you got COVID four times. Yeah, but I know they changed their tune a couple of times, but the reality is I haven't had the COVID vaccine in a year. We didn't get it. And it wasn't because I was against it or anything. It's just because we didn't get to it and didn't get it. And I had also thought I'd had it three times. Well, I'll probably be okay. And then I got it a fourth time. But I think with the vaccine, and maybe I would have had mild cases anyway, but, you know, they say that with the vaccine, you'll have a milder case of COVID. And then, you know, you think about a lot of the long COVID stuff that goes on. I think you have to worry about that, too. That is something worth worrying about. You get COVID, and I wonder, you know, some of these long COVID symptoms don't go away at all.
That may be the answer to some of your immunocompromisation.
Could very well be. Could very well be.
That's
so,
even worse.
Anyway, it is what it is. Take it for what it is. But I just find that we're questioning things today, and we're very inconsistent in what we question. So why question this, but you don't question things over here? To me, it just doesn't make sense. That's just my take. Take it for what it is. And by the way, don't chase around an armadillo because you could get leprosy. The Falcon Clinic in Washington Mills is accepting new patients. The Falcon Clinic is the area's premier osteopathic medical clinic, and they're accepting new patients right now. Osteopathy, where there are the importance of your body, things flowing through your body the way they are supposed to. Like anything else, if you get a stuffed up nose, it causes headaches. It causes all sorts of pressure in your head, things that you just don't feel well.
Yeah.
Well, the same thing can happen in your body. And an osteopathic approach can have a great effect on your health and wellness. But also it may mean you still might need medicine. You may have hereditary high blood pressure and still need medicine for blood pressure. That's all part of the Falcon Clinic. Dr. Shemileski, Dr. Zielinski, even acupuncture with Dr. Kosminski, all under one roof at the Falcon Clinic in Washington Mills. They're accepting new patients today. Call 315-507-4751. 315-507-4751. Accepting new patients right now. The Falcon Clinic in Washington Mills.
If we get sick, we're at higher risk. But we're absolutely not going to stop living our lives. And what helps us do that? Getting our flu shot, the updated COVID vaccine. Yeah, we stay on top of these things so that we can do the things that we love with the people we love, because we don't want to miss out.
A message from the New York State Department of Health.
Scott and Jill here from New York Sash with a trivia question for you. How long do you think it takes in weeks to train a bath and shower installer to be 100% ready to tackle a project by themselves?
It's an important random independent contractors to install their bathrooms. And usually they're plumbers or handymen, and they may not know the ins and outs of bathroom remodeling, which means, well, they're going to make mistakes.
At New York Sash, our installers are actual employees. We put them through a rigorous training program where they apprentice with a master craftsman for 60 weeks.
60. So when they show up to install your new bath or shower, it's going to be perfect. It takes 60 weeks, but it's worth it.
Call New York Sash now and get 15% off windows, doors, or bathrooms, plus low APR financing. 315-624-7344 or online at newyorksash.com.
Hi, this is Scott Trout of Cordell & Cordell. There are a lot of great dads out there. Sometimes those dads get divorced. For more than 30 years, we've represented men in divorce, confronting the pitfalls that could devastate your finances or harm your family relationships. While every situation is different, our goal is to get the best outcome for you and your kids. Visit CordellCordell.com to take the first step.
518-554-0000. 100 Great Oaks Boulevard, Suite 110, Albany, New York, 12203. Online at CordellCordell.com.
From the Stanley Theater Studio, WIBX 950 Utica Rome, W295 DI Utica Rome, your news, talk, and sports leader, a Town Square Media Station.
Some homes are now twisted apart rubble. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News, after tornadoes hit three states.
It's devastating. You know, you look at the damage and you're like, wow, how could something like this happen?
He's in Milton, Kentucky, in Indiana.
I heard what sounded like a train, and then I started hearing sirens and things like that.
Bob McCoy is the mayor of Winchester, where there's a lot of damage east of Indianapolis and many people injured.
I'm shaking. It's overwhelming.
There's also destruction and death in Ohio. At least six people killed in the Indian Lake area northwest of Columbus. Hamas has a new ceasefire proposal for Gaza, including hostage releases. And Israel's war cabinet's considering it today, but the prime minister's already said Hamas's terms are unrealistic. The father of a school shooter has been found guilty in Michigan. James Crumbly, convicted of involuntary manslaughter, just like the boy's mother last month.
I refuse to take a victory lap with these prosecutions. It will not bring back these kids.
Oakland County Prosecutor Karen McDonald. James Crumley provided the gun that Ethan used to murder four classmates at Oxford High in 2021. Both parents also accused of not doing enough to treat their son's mental illness. Ethan's now in prison for life. Former President Trump is waiting for a judge's ruling in Georgia today in the defense attempt to get District Attorney Fani Willis removed from the election interference case over a romantic relationship with the special prosecutor that she hired. While in New York, another Trump criminal case is set to go to trial in 10 days, but it may be pushed back.
New evidence includes about 31,000 pages of additional records from federal prosecutors in New York, according to Manhattan District Attorney Alvin Bragg. The Trump legal team says the information was unfairly withheld and asked for a 90-day delay to review it. Prosecutors have suggested a 30-day delay instead.
Fox's Tonya J. Powers, the former president, is charged with falsifying records in that case over hush money payments in 2016 to keep an alleged affair quiet. America's listening to Fox News.
Hi, I'm Martha Stewart. Every year, more than 4 million pets enter shelters here in the United States. My friends at American Humane have been helping animals since 1877. The goal is to ensure that pets have a safe shelter, especially during natural disasters. Adopting a shelter pet allows shelters to help more animals awaiting care. Please consider adopting today and take some time to learn more about American Humane's other work at AmericanHumane.org.
Pure Talk believes in American values and that free should mean exactly that, free. Well, switch to Pure Talk today and you'll get a free Samsung 5G smartphone. Now, qualifying plans start at just $35 a month for unlimited talk, text, 15 gigs of data, and, of course, mobile hotspot. Just dial #250, say the keyword Pure Talk, claim your eligibility for your free brand new Samsung 5G smartphone. Start saving on wireless today and switch to my cell phone company, Pure Talk.
2 days before St. Patrick's Day, President Biden will meet with Irish leaders, including the Prime Minister, at the White House. But some lawmakers from Ireland are skipping the trip to the U.S., critical of the president's support for Israel in the war in Gaza. Vice President Harris will meet with the Irish Prime Minister first, having breakfast with him this hour, the day after she put a big focus on abortion rights, a key issue for Democrats in the 2024 campaign.
Vice President Kamala Harris went to a Planned Parenthood clinic in St. Paul and acknowledged during remarks that many have asked her why she was there.
Right now in our country, we are facing a very serious health crisis.
She said since Roe was overturned in the Dobbs decision, she's met women who were denied abortions, but also in states that have passed restrictive laws against the procedure, women's health clinics that provided more than just abortions have shut down.
It is also, as I mentioned earlier, essential and critical reproductive health care like PAPs, like breast cancer screenings.
Minnesota was just one stop on her Fight for Reproductive Freedom's tour. She's previously been to Wisconsin, Georgia, Michigan, and Arizona. Jessica Rosenthal, Fox News.
A college sports controversy has been taken to court.
Former Kentucky swimmer Riley Gaines is one of 16 athletes who allege the NCAA's transgender policy is a violation of Title IX and deprives women of their constitutional right to bodily privacy.
What we are hoping for out of this lawsuit is, one, accountability, two, responsibility, and three, for the NCAA to implement Title IX by its original intent,
Speaking with Fox's Martha McCallum on the story, the suit details the shock swimmers felt learning they were competing against Leah Thomas, a transgender swimmer who won the 2022 National Championships. The NCAA, which is yet to comment, revising its policies on transgender participation in 2022 following the U.S. Olympic and Paralympic Committee. Kristen Goodwin, Fox News.
On Wall Street, stock futures are rising after yesterday's selling. I'm Dave Anthony. This is Fox News.
Good morning. Happy Friday. WIBX 950 News Time, 8:05. I'm Andrew Domenico. 44 degrees under cloudy skies. Your full weather forecast is coming up. This update brought to you by Standards and Stories with Tony Danza, coming in April to the Stanley Theater. Tickets are available now through Ticketmaster. Again, there was an injury-related crash on the New York State Thruway this morning between exits 33 and 32 going eastbound. The right lane remains blocked, but the left lane is open. Do be mindful of that if you have to travel that route. Give yourself a little extra time. With a lot of people heading out to celebrate St. Patrick's Day, police statewide are going to be keeping a very close eye out for drunk drivers. Travelers can expect to see increased patrols on the road and will begin today and run through Sunday. Folks who are planning to drink alcohol are urged to make sure they have a safe ride home. Designated driver. Anyone who sees suspicious or dangerous activity while driving should dial 911 immediately. Onondaga County Executive Ryan McMahon has given his sixth State of the County address since taking office. Part of the speech in Syracuse yesterday focused on the pending arrival of Micron Technology, which is looking to build a new facility in Clay. McMahon says he's optimistic about the future of the county and highlighted things that are on the horizon, such as a new aquarium. His office is also planning to focus on economic development, enhancing child care facilities, and improving mental health services. Starting today, Destiny USA in Syracuse is going to start offering free glasses for people who want to use them to view the upcoming solar eclipse. All anyone has to do is sign up to become part of the mall's mailing list. Once that is completed, they'll be eligible to get two pairs of glasses on a first-come, first-served basis. These glasses will be located at the guest services desk, the first level of the mall below the carousel. The solar eclipse is happening on April 8th.
I also think everybody's selling them. There are a lot of places where you can buy them. Davey.
When I went to get the donuts this morning for Andrew up at Stewart's, they had sun solar glasses at the counter.
Yeah, I think Stewart's is one that's selling them. Good luck, though, trying to get past the people in line buying lottery tickets for tonight's this weekend's big
I'll
lottery.
I'll take two number threes, four ones.
Well,
16,
and remember 17. The both the Powerball and the Mega Millions. The Mega Millions is up to almost $800 million, and Powerball is like almost 600. It's just crazy, the world we live in.
It is.
This is incredible.
Indeed,
I love every bit of it.
Let's get another one.
Okay.
The U.S. District Court at 10 Broad Street in Utica was filled with cheers, applause, and waving American flags.
This is the greatest event that happens in Utica. This
it
with
is.
Judge Hurd. I was a part of it once.
52 individuals from 20 nations were sworn in as American citizens on Wednesday, March 14th. U.S. District Court Judge Hurd presided over the ceremony, who welcomed all of the new citizens and their loved ones and encouraged them to celebrate this accomplishment. Hurd says, "Usually this courtroom is quiet, somber, all sorts of things, but not today. I want you to cheer. I want you to clap with your families and friends. This is your great day." It is 8:08. Your weather forecast is brought to you by the new Destination Kia of Utica on Commercial Drive in Yorkville.
My Witness News Chief Meteorologist Craig Flint in the WIBX Weather Center. Today, leftover shower early, then drier, breezy, cooler afternoon. Gradually clearing sky, a high near 50. Tonight, partly to mostly cloudy, a low of 36. And for parade day Saturday, mostly cloudy, dry for the parade, then some afternoon clearing, a high of 52. For more on your local forecast, tune to Eyewitness News at 6 on WTR. Meteorologist Craig Flint on WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM.
45 degrees under cloudy skies. It's 8:09. The big game is tomorrow night at the Adirondack Bank Center. Plymouth State University taking on number nine
The Pioneers will take on number 9 Plymouth State University at the Adirondack Bank Center, and it is sure to be a great game. It's the quarterfinal round of the NCAA tournament, so get out there. If tickets are still available...
I'm working on that now, so at the end of the sports, I'll tell you which seats are available and which are not.
Yeah, okay? Regardless of what's available or not, get them while you still can, because it's going to be a big game, and they'll need all the home crowd support they can get.
This is really, when you think about it, this is such an important game. The last few years, since COVID, the Pioneers have had a problem, and they lose in this game. They get a bye. They're ranked high in the tournament, and they lose in this game. So there's a jinx on us that we're going to break this weekend. I'm very excited about it.
Hopefully. Utica Comets have home action tonight against the Hershey Bears. That puck drops at 7 p.m., and then they travel to Hartford to face the Wolfpack tomorrow at 6 p.m. Also, the New York Mets... got a win. Actually, the Mets and Cardinals play to a scoreless tie in Jupiter. Jose Buto started the game for the Mets and struck out 3 batters while allowing 2 hits over 4 innings pitched. New York will host the Washington Nationals tonight in Port St. Lucie. The Yankees were clobbered by the Tigers 7-0, or I should say mauled by the Tigers 7-0 in Lakeland. Marcus Stroman got the start and allowed 5 runs, 4 of them earned on 7 hits over 4 and a third innings pitched. New York will look to snap their 3-game losing streak when they host the Pirates tonight at George Steinbrenner Stadium in Tampa. The Knicks have won back-to-back games after topping the Portland Trailblazers 105-93 at Moda Center. New York is now second in the Atlantic Division at 39-27. Some NFL free agency news. The Chicago Bears are making a major splash in the trade market. The team acquired all 6-time Pro Bowl wide receiver Keenan Allen from the Chargers Thursday. The Bears sent back a 4th-round pick in this year's NFL draft to complete the trade. Allen set a career high with receptions of 108 in 2023. The Commanders traded Sam Howell, a 4th-round pick, and a 6th-rounder to Seattle in exchange for a 3rd-round and 5th-round pick in this year's draft. Howell is expected to back up Geno Smith, and the Texans have given an extension already to Joe Mixon, the running back they just signed from Cincinnati. They've agreed to a 3-year, $27 million contract. $13 million is guaranteed money. And the Players' Championship round is come and gone. Xander Schauffele and Rory McIlroy and Wyndham Clark are tied atop the leaderboard after the first round of the Players' Championship. After it was suspended due to darkness, defending champion Scotty Scheffler is tied with several other players for 6th at 5 under par, and Christopher Bell will hope to become the first driver to win multiple races this season at the NASCAR Cup Series as it rolls into Bristol, Tennessee on Sunday. WIBX 950 news time is 8:13.
All right, I want to tell you about what's available for Plymouth State versus Utica and how big this game is. The seats are all sold. There are some seats available. In, for instance, Section 101, Section 100 and 101, there are a lot of seats left. They just released seats because of they're not being used by Plymouth. But, Andrew, I'm really shocked by the number of seats available for this game tomorrow night.
Yeah, I am too. I think that'll change. You know, we're a last-minute market, quote-unquote, as they call
it. I guess,
it, but
look around. 208 has a ton of seats available.
Get your butt in there.
201 does. But these dark blue along here, you can see this right on the map. Each of these have a medium amount of seats left. Like, for instance, go to section 203. Look at that. All the upper seats are available.
I don't understand why that is.
Because every seat at the odd is such a good seat. And then now...
a lot of people are probably just going to show up and get tickets.
The gray is sold out, so all around the ice is sold out with a few exceptions. But then you've got the darker, all these darker sections right here. Are you seeing this?
Oh, yeah.
All these darker sections have plenty of seats left for tomorrow night. So get in there and get your tickets. They're available online or at the box office of the Adirondack Bank Center. Coming up, Mayor Galime will have in studio here this morning, making his way in. River Hills Properties has a brand new TV show coming, and it will debut Sunday, April 7th. We'll have more details on that. It's called Sold in Upstate New York. River Hills Properties is the number one independent real estate agency in the entire area. Number two, if you include the big chains, and it's all about the services provided that they provide. Your listing agent is there every time the house is shown. Somebody that's never been in your house before and a listing agent from somewhere else that's never been in your house before aren't allowed to type in a code and walk through your house when you're not there. If you're not home with River Hills, your listing agent is there. If you're home, your listing agent is there to answer questions, to make sure the lights are on, the house is ready to be shown, and you're putting your best foot forward. And there's the book, which is basically the manual for the home. Every improvement, everything there is to know about the home, all included in the book. Like I said, it's like a manual for the home. They have offices in Barneville, Little Falls, and Utica. Online, it's RiverHillsPropertiesLLC.com. Call 315-896-1009. Remember, nobody sells homes like River Hills Properties. Also, I'll tell you, the official coffee of the program is Daylight Donuts in New Hartford. And whether you're in for the espresso, the coffee, the lattes, iced coffee, breakfast sandwiches, the bagels, all made fresh every single morning, it's Daylight Donuts. The drive-through is lightning fast. And my favorite, with this Easter dinner coming up just a couple of weeks away, get on the list and order snowflake rolls for your Easter dinner. You don't have to worry about the rolls. You pick them up the day before or even on Easter Sunday, and they are fresh and will melt in your mouth for your Easter dinner.
They're made with real snowflakes, too.
If you do not have, if you're not, you have to be on the list in order to get them. So call over to Daylight Donuts, 315-724-7103, or through the drive-thru, or stop in and reserve a dozen or two dozen for your Easter dinner. Snowflake rolls at Daylight Donuts in New Hartford.
Right?
Yep, thanks for checking. I like the car. How long have you been a rideshare driver?
About 3 years now. I really enjoy it.
Isn't it hard to make money these days with the price of gas being so high?
Not for me. I use Upside, the free app that gives you cash back for every gallon of gas you buy.
Wait a minute. Are you saying you actually get real money back when you get gas with the Upside app?
Yep, I get real cash back every time I get gas.
Does that actually add up to anything?
I'll make around $200 to $300.
Wow, that's serious extra cash. I'm downloading the Upside app now.
Download the free Upside app now to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code GEAR for an extra 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. You can cash out anytime right to your bank account, PayPal, or a gift card for Amazon and other brands. Just download the free Upside app and use promo code GEAR for a 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. That's code GEAR.
They're pounding on the door. They're calling on the phone. They're threatening to close your business. If debt has your business on the brink, call Ray Reynolds, the godfather of credit. For over 40 years, Ray Reynolds has helped thousands of customers get millions in cash credit. It's no wonder why they call Ray the godfather of credit. He may even be able to raise your score above 750 before the end of the year. You could even get a new personal or business credit line up to $50,000 within days. If your credit needs a rebuild, call Ray Reynolds and receive a $1,000 cash credit card at closing. Raise your credit score to 750 or more. Call Ray Reynolds at 800-537-7008. 800-537-7008. Learn about Ray's secrets to success and how he can fix and improve your credit score to 750 or more. Call the godfather of credit rebuild, Ray Reynolds, at 800-537-7008. 800-537-7008.
It's the spring preseason hot tub super sale going on at Liverpool Pool and Spa East Dominic Street in Rome. In-stock models on sale now, and it's the lowest prices of the season. Saltwater hot tubs sold by Hot Spring Spas, the number one manufacturer of hot tubs nationwide. You get instant cash rebates or 0% financing so you can start your wellness journey today. Liverpool Pool and Spa, 1501 East Dominic Street, Rome, or LiverpoolPoolandSpa.com.
sneezing, coughing, stuffy nose, runny nose, post-nasal drip, interrupted sleeping. I was groggy at the end of the day.
Allergies and sinus congestion were making Jana miserable. Then, a friend recommended Navage. Navage provides immediate drug-free congestion relief, flushing your nasal passages with refreshing saline and sucking out mucus, germs, and other airborne irritants. Navage helps you breathe easier, sleep better, and feel your best right away.
Navage gave me instant relief. I didn't have to wait 30 minutes. I didn't have to wait an hour, 90 minutes. I didn't have to wait a minute. I ran the rinse and I felt better.
Stop suffering from congestion and start breathing and feeling your best again with Navage. N-A-V-A-G-E.
I've had people ask me how I find relief, and I tell them Navage immediately. This thing is amazing.
Navage is available at Navage.com or at Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, and Rite Aid.
Some stores will tell you they carry Purple Mattress, but they may only have two or three on the floor. Only Mattress Express has 9 different purples on the floor. Stop into any Mattress Express store, try all the purples, and then we'll pull up the website and give you the same price as online.
X 950 and 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
Friday morning before St. Patrick's Parade Day. That's tomorrow. A couple of comments in here this morning. I got a bunch, actually. And our man 540 on YouTube, I want to get to yours. You've got a bunch of topics that
he's firing them off.
He's firing them off today. Mike says, unfortunately, this vaccine hesitancy that is occurring is now causing a drop in traditional vaccinations like measles, mumps, etc., causing an uptick in this among children. Yeah, I completely agree. I think that's a problem. Somebody said Jake Morgan is a character. Is there a stipend for being a councilman? Because that's why he works for candidates. He's looking for a job. Talking about Jake Morgan, who is running.
He's running for trustee in the village of Whitesboro.
I saw that on a pickup truck, actually.
Yeah. Well, he has some interesting theories on autism. And again, Facebook is one of the worst places to see this stuff spread. Yeah. So much anecdotal conclusion. So many anecdotal conclusions are made on Facebook, and there's no proof. There's no proof. That's the problem.
Well, when you do research on Facebook,
it's always a good place. That's where I always start.
And,
research.
In college, you learn to cite your sources. Yes. And if your sources are like, happy, lucky 738, yeah, and some Facebook
right.
handle.
I mean, when you if you go to a good college, the college will tell you, do not ever walk through this door and hand me a paper that cites Wikipedia as your source.
Right.
And I mean, Wikipedia is pretty accurate. The problem is
anybody can edit it.
Yeah, depending on the day, if they don't review the edit,
that's right.
You could have some interesting facts.
So, but Facebook is far worse than Wikipedia. And if universities and colleges don't accept Wikipedia, they do not accept Facebook. But you're right. When the name is happy-go-lucky 24.
They're ready to celebrate this weekend.
Well, people forget, though, the whole reason Facebook started was so Zuckerberg could get some girls.
I think that.
that's what you're utilizing.
That is absolutely true.
As an application. Yeah.
All right. In studio is the mayor of, and you're in Studio B, our Studio B for basement.
Yes.
And you've made it down here.
To do this. It just sounded so Wayne's World to me that I wanted to make it down here.
And it kind of is.
It
like
is.
Wayne's.
I
That's
got down here and I'm like, wow, there's guitars and
a leather couch.
Fun stuff.
Yeah.
Signs. There's a reel to reel. Which, that's not an 808. What's that? That's a 4-track.
That's a 4-track.
Yeah.
So.
Look at that.
Which,
Galime,
by the way,
the technological
I have 4 reel-to-reel machines down here. None of them work.
You know what's a bummer about
them? I cannot find anyone to work on them
it's
today.
It's not just that. Well, my Uncle Yaj used to at EG Electronics, right? But here's the problem.
Would he work on it today?
No.
Okay.
No. Well, he might. But here's the problem. If you utilize your reel-to-reel, you'll notice that if hook up a recording device if you're going to play them, because all of the actual magnetic material will come off them as you play it. It just goes to dust.
It
and then
does.
You have to clean the heads with a Q-tip every 28 seconds.
Listen, we used to, with those reel-to-reels, and with ones that were far less capable than those two-track, four-track, or we had an eight-track at one point. But and the tape on those is really, really thick. It's cool. But, you know, here we are in a radio studio, and the radio station says you can't put live calls on the air. Everything has to be recorded. And here you are whipping with a razor blade. I mean, back in the day, quoting our man Fred.
Back in my day.
Back in the day, I was pretty good with a razor blade and cutting up tape because you had to
was
do it.
Was it Edgar Winter?
And you had like 3 minutes. You had 3 minutes to get it done.
Yeah.
I don't know what Edgar Winter did. I never really
Edgar
followed
Winter
that much,
was
but.
Like famous for cutting all his tunes together with the razors. That's, right. I mean, that's how you did it back then.
That's how you did it. That's
you
that's
know, my
what
buddy
did.
Adam went to school at Herkimer not too long ago. This had to be 10 years ago. They were still teaching that. As like
that sounds like Cal Sokoloff,
who's
the professor down there. And
or he was, right? I don't know if that program's still there.
The program is no longer there.
That's
very sad. All right, so we have a lot to get to. Number one, stray animals. Let's start with that.
Okay.
What's happening? I know that the police department? I don't really know this story.
So the Anita Stevens. Yeah, the Anita Stevens Swans basically used to take the strays from the city of Utica, but now there's some sort of dispute.
I wouldn't call it a dispute. So the contract was expired as of March 2023.
Okay.
So last March, we did, and when I say we, that's the administration, last year, still funded Anita's at $250,000 in this budget year, even though there was no contract.
Yeah, yeah.
And what they did is they said, okay, well, if we're not going to have a contract, we're going to go per diem. As of February 15th this year, Anita said the per diem has run out. We no longer can take animals. So the chief of staff, Mike Gentile, and the police department, and everyone started putting our heads together. And they purchased the proper equipment, called up New York State Ag and Markets, and set up a temporary shelter. And it is certified for 30 days. So right now, within the scope of the city, we are handling the actual dog
for
situation
yeah.
for now. Well, so I did refund that line in the budget proposal, same amount, $250,000, which a couple of years ago I was the person who really advocated to get that from $120 to $250.
I got to tell you, when you think about that, this is a great example of the rest of us looking on and like, well, I can't believe so-and-so's making this much money, or I can't believe they spend so much on A, B, and C. But it you don't. There are so many expenses that a city has to deal with that the average person would never think about.
Well, a lot of people, salt. I know we're talking about the animals right now, but
salt
right? There's I was talking
one,
to somebody,
yeah.
They're like, what do you mean salt? I said, yeah, our salt, we have to contract 7,000 tons of salt a year.
So
no matter
only,
what, we have to buy it. It's like $500,000.
Not only roads,
salt.
Even if you
not
have
only
a,
roads, but you have to deal with walkways.
Yeah,
and
everything. Yes.
Even if you have a mild winter like this, you got
well,
to
so we have a storage facility, for example. If we buy that much salt, don't use it, it does roll over to next year. But we contract 7,000 a year.
All right.
So back to the animals.
So the animal thing
dogs.
Seems like you're working on a deal, and this will be dealt with.
The UPD will have their space back, essentially.
Yeah, exactly. Which I have to commend everyone who's working on this. Everyone really stood up and said, we have to take care of this for the good of the animals. The animals that we've held past the period that we're legally required to hold, we've been able to find shelters for, which is great. Some of them have been adopted.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's a 30-day temporary, and as of April 1st, it'll be refunded again. So whether we're in a contract or we're in per diem, you know, we had a really good meeting with Anita's this week. We met with their board.
I want to just clarify the word refunded. So it'll be funded again.
Yes, yes. As of April 1st, when this budget passes. Yeah, sorry. The funding line will be replenished.
That's good.
Let's put it that way.
Fair enough.
So we're going to work something out.
I want to switch to, we had a former councilwoman come on.
Okay.
Former candidate for mayor.
Oh, okay.
We've had KDILO on, and you know what they have done at the Common Council. They think they can get this down to below 1%. And I'm assuming you've seen all the cuts that have been made.
Well, they're proposed, yes.
Well,
they're amendments, yes.
All the cuts that have been made in their proposal.
I don't think they're down that low any longer.
They're not.
No.
Where are they now, do you think?
Because
I got to say that a lot of the cuts, I'm like, so which expert did you use to cut these programs with the police department and with the fire department?
Well,
and I think that once explained, a lot of times we it's easy to say, these people don't know what they're doing. What are they thinking? And then you find out what A, B, and C is for, and you're like, okay, it does make sense.
So which things are you talking about?
There were 80 items.
A ton. Yeah. So, I mean, when the first round was proposed, when they were, you know, stating they could get it below 2%, which, you know, proved even within their own scope not possible.
Well, the initial was below 1%.
Right, and that was floated to basically say, oh, we're going to meet in the middle. But when the bottom of what you consider the middle is completely unrealistic.
Yeah, yeah.
Now you have to get back to the drawing board. But, you know, the parking garage, you know, Kennedy Garage, $1.5 million. I stated multiple times that can't be in there. That's still up for consideration because you have to remember they still have meetings. Their meeting is on the 20th. The amendment, you know, process is not done yet by any means. So anything could happen in between now and Wednesday.
Did MVHS not purchase that facility, though?
So there was an agreement from the Common Council to allow URE to sell it, but a purchase sale agreement was not concluded. It's not done, but even if it is done, we have to move the signal maintenance facility. We have to move the facility maintenance. We also have to arrange for a lot of different parking. So there's a lot of expense in moving that. So that $1.5 million, if it was to be brought into, you know, the city, you know, as the executive, I would want to set that aside as a capital reserve so that when we have to either build or relocate facilities and signal maintenance, we have that money. You don't want to just use that.
Plus, you don't know what it's going to be after it's all said and done.
Right, exactly. Yeah. And the new news on that one is we have to move the generator and our electrical entrance because Kennedy Garage and the City Hall are really one building.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, interesting.
Okay. So that's just one area. And when you say, I don't think they're as low as they thought they were going to be, where do you think they are now?
If I had to guess realistically, and these are their amendments. I'm not saying any of these amendments are agreeable or reasonable at this point because I have to wait till their final package is done and review it.
Yeah.
But I think they're probably around like 8 or 9 is where I think they are.
And that's unfinished business to
begin
with.
Right, and that's unfinished business as well. Yeah.
Okay.
So are you up for or open to
WIB?
Oh, I finally got that to work.
Nice.
The space bar now triggers.
Scared the hell
I've been wanting that to happen. sorry.
Are you open to negotiation from the 16.5%? Are you open? Can you see? Are you open-minded to some of their amendments?
So I'll say the exact same thing I said since I proposed the budget. If there are reasonable amendments that will not cut a department to dysfunction because we're already there in a lot of spaces.
Right,
I will consider that.
Well,
now,
that is something that's really important. In other words, what you're saying is the cuts have already been made to the point where it's difficult for people to do their job.
In the first place.
In the first place. And to cut more
Think about last year's campaign. Everyone said more public safety. Everyone said, we aren't mowing the parks. Why can't we weed eat around the benches?
Yeah,
why are the fields not ready? The whole year last year was we need more. And what I'm trying to do is just at least keep it the same and run everything more efficiently so that we can get more work done. But, yeah, cutting to further dysfunction is definitely not a good idea at this juncture.
And I do fear that. And let's not forget that Utica has added new expenses.
Many.
With the ARPA funding, you've added expenses all of a sudden.
Right, and the departmental request, for example, to run this ice skating rink was $200,000. I lowered it to $100,000. I said, well, we're going to have to make do with what we have because it's there. A lot of other things. Now,
and you've put the kibosh on some other projects like the water slide and things like that.
Right, but that's not really going to affect the operational budget. What that's doing is shoring up a lot of capital project, whether capital with the city or capital through ARPA, that money's, you know, that will be used to shore up projects that we're behind so that we don't have to further go into debt.
I bring up something, and I've not gotten there to take a look at it, but I've seen photos, I've seen video. The Franklin Square, what used to be a building is now that alleyway.
Correct.
So I believe that's where the mural. The mural went up, and
it's next to our Riverdale.
Oh, it's not the alleyway. You're thinking the mural is on the other side. But okay, yes, then that's the block. That's the block.
I am thinking about the alleyway.
Yes.
So that area. So benches have been put in there.
Mm-hmm.
And this new,
I said mural, but it looks like.
Oh, you mean on the floor, on the ground?
On the ground. Yeah,
yeah. It's like a mural on the ground. Yeah.
Well, it's green. It's green.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So it seems like that's made of recycled materials, and probably glass.
Yeah, it looks like crushed glass. Yes.
There are elements of it where we've heard reports from people that if a kid were to be walking through there without shoes on, they would probably cut their feet. The other problem. And I just want your take on it. The other problem is that because it is, let's say, coarse, mm-hmm. without saying sharp, let's say it's coarse, it's garbage is getting caught. So as it blows through, it's becoming
it's like sandpaper almost.
It's like sandpaper, and it's catching the garbage. People over in that neighborhood are complaining, saying that the all of that money that went into it is creating new problems.
Right, so
what do you know about, and can you look into it?
Well, I will walk it barefoot.
Walk it barefoot.
And I will
get a bed of hot coals as well.
I'll do that. But that was Council Person Aiello's Keystone project, I believe, under the Palmieri administration. And like I said, I will walk it barefoot if that's the complaint. But I know with a lot of the crushed glass, you know, it should be no different than the coarse concrete they do, so that, you know, it's not a slippery surface. But
if you look at pictures, it does seem the garbage is getting trapped.
I haven't been down there since the winter. I walked it prior, but spring is hitting.
It is spring, and that's when things look ugly till we clean it up.
We'll have to check it out.
Check that out if you would.
But my take is I will walk it barefoot.
I'll
come back on the show and give you a report.
The barefoot report.
He's not a mayor, he's a martyr, for God's sakes.
I'll call in while I'm walking it.
That's what I'm going to do.
Let's do it. All right.
Of course, Lance and Lee chiming in this morning. Bill, a few weeks ago I questioned Utica spending $100,000 on a chief of staff. There was
which that's not true. I got to put that out there. Yeah,
he said he denied that it was that much. According to the new proposed budget, it's $89,000 plus benefits, which total well over $100,000.
Right. I don't know where he's reading these numbers.
Okay. All right, what's the number, and what's the number with benefits?
The number is just under 70 for the chief of staff.
Okay,
over 70.
Okay.
75, I believe.
All right.
I think that's in the budget. These are budget numbers. So the $100,000 thing was a rumor started by multiple people, including people on the radio show, which caused our chief of staff quite a bit of grief, actually, because then he was walking around and people are asking why he was making $100,000 a year. And
he was asking, where's my $100,000?
He's like, you know, I'd love to be making this extra $25,000 a year.
So, and I guess the question
in the benefits, I mean, there's no real benefits. He's got health insurance and retirement. You know?
I think those would.
But, I mean, that's standard. Number, there's no, like, fringe benefits. Like, no one's paying for his college or anything nonsense. He's just getting paid to do a job. And he's doing a really good job of it.
So, with that said, mm-hmm. how does that reflect when it comes to similar-sized cities around the state and what a chief of staff should make?
We are well underfunded. Even locally, there's chief of staffs, which I'm not going to name names and cause all the same rumor mill that the caller did a couple weeks ago with my chief of staff salary, but he's literally making half as much as other chief of staffs. I got to say, across the board, if you look at our city salaries compared to the county, compared to Syracuse, many the people who live and work in Utica, New York, truly want to work here, because they could be taking jobs elsewhere in a minute.
And making more money.
Yeah, yeah.
Budget director.
Yes, we have one starting next week.
Because I feel like that
he hasn't onboarded yet, so I'm not going to, like, throw his name out there and all that stuff.
But could be a very important for right now.
Oh, my
this
gosh,
position
yes,
is extremely
yes,
important.
Absolutely.
And then public safety commissioner.
So public safety commissioner, I started the interview process for and started collecting names, but at the same time, it's kind of in contention with the council right now. So I have
They don't want to hire someone?
They want to cut. One of their amendments is defunding the public safety commissioner, which is interesting because the person who submitted that amendment, with other names on it, of course, campaigned all last year for another mayor candidate on the fact that we were going to hire a full-time public safety commissioner. Yeah. Now that person wants to cut it because it's me proposing it. Yeah. But we'll see what happens. Yeah.
Well, I think that position is important.
It's really important.
Yeah.
Very important.
Yeah. And you don't want to take that job yourself.
Well, right. So here's the thing. It's a second-class cities law mandated position. So right now I attempted to see if first week of January, I said, who could I appoint so it's not the mayor, right? We couldn't really... I tried to appoint someone in Corporation Council just temporarily, to find somebody, but it was a conflict. So right now I am effectively still the public safety commissioner, which that's why I really want to make sure we can arrange that appropriately.
All right. Anything else you want to make sure that people know about?
Lance, again, one more question. Okay. Please ask, with the new hospital complete, what is the final loss of revenue from property and sales tax losses from the absence of those businesses?
And I want to add on that, because we've been told that when you look at everything collectively, there's actually more tax revenue being generated once the medical facility is open than was being generated down there before.
I mean, it's a large development. We did lose direct property tax to both the city, the school, and the library, as well as the county. So as funding streams start to tick up, we'll have to do different type of actuarial analysis on that.
But
the hospital as a whole, as far as bringing in business into Utica, it's going to tick up our preemption. We have a sales tax preemption if money is spent in Utica. So, and having the people downtown specifically will help that preemption.
And you've got to already be feeling that now. Feeling the beginning of that. I mean, I know it's confusing with the garage not open, which won't be open until summer.
What I was
going to
say, though, is we had a lot of that through construction, and now it's kind of just trading off. So we've already kind of seen it.
Yeah.
And it's already baked in.
Yeah. Very good point. Yeah. The hotels have certainly are still reaping the benefit.
Oh, yeah.
In the area. And then one more thing I want to throw out there is – Utica is going to be in the spotlight coming up next month.
Yes, we have.
This is big.
USA Hockey.
Yeah.
We have. This is, a couple years ago, I went to see the World Cup event for the Luge up in Lake Placid.
Yeah.
That's what's going on here in Utica in a couple weeks. That's it's so significant. I can't explain how happy I am as a mayor and as just a resident to see these types of things coming in. Nexus is bringing in more and more, and just the pure like hype and pride. You see it not just because of that, but you see it with the Comets games, you see it with the Pioneers games, you see it because the kids are now playing in that same facility with like the people they're idolizing and getting signatures from. It's really creating that sports reality again in Utica that I grew up with the Devils.
It's so exciting. I almost feel like it's
phenomenal.
It's even...
Oh, no, it's way bigger. Way bigger than it ever was. Yeah. Way bigger.
And this event is going to be, hotels, restaurants, everything going to be packed during this 2.5 weeks. But it's even longer than that because some of these teams, I believe I saw the Chinese team is already here. Some of these teams are arriving right now.
The effects of this
is beginning. And when Rob Ash and Tony Pacini were out talking about what Nexus was going to do, look at it.
This is it. So the other thing that's going on, sports is huge. Mm-hmm. Right now, we've also got the NCAA tournament in Herkimer.
Yes.
Okay, 12 teams. National basketball D3 tournament. Started last night.
Herkimer win?
Yeah, they are literally all staying in Utica, New York, playing all the games in Herkimer. I mean, this region is hosting some major events.
Herkimer is really well known for their sports, and this is just a great example of that. So
it is.
It's a good time. We need to make sure we take advantage of these things, make the most of them. That's what we've done all of this work. And now the most crucial time is, do we take advantage of it and go to the next level?
So that's what I wanted to leave people with. There's been a lot of chatter and talk about, my budget proposal not having compassion for the people. And if you really look at the numbers and how I've always proceeded in the community, it absolutely does. It's just unfortunately also, heavy with reality. And right now is not the time to stop taking care of the city.
Yep.
There's never a time to stop taking care of the city. And, you know, this budget proposal moving forward after it passes is necessary and needed. And I absolutely want to make sure that the people who live in the city of Utica that wake up and go to sleep every day in the city of Utica have a functional city to live in. And that's what compassion is. That's what empathy is. You have to make sure people have a place to live.
Mike asking, is there something going on with a landfill cleanup in Utica?
There is.
What is that?
So the DEC is currently moving dredge spoils, which dredge spoils sounds like a dirty word, but it's like, you know, they dredge the canal.
Yeah.
It's just sand. We've moved on. If you look in the ENA, minutes a couple weeks ago, we hired an environmental lawyer. This has been something that's been pending for almost 20 years now. The DEC has labeled that old incinerator road dump as something that needs to be cleaned up and capped. And one of the first things I had to act on is get the ball rolling on that. Now, in 2018, the Paul Mary administration did sign something with the DEC saying, if you get around to it, you can start moving dredge spoils there because it's going to have to happen. And then in 2022, we were locked into working with New York Power Authority. The plan is to, finalize what that's going to look like, where it's going to be capped, set aside some acreage for a potential public safety training facility that will also be capped and cleaned, okay? And then, work towards RFPing a solar farm so that the funding, which we might need up to $40 million to clean this up, okay?
Wow.
Sins of the past, $40 million. Hopefully, we can work out a deal with the DEC where the revenues from that solar farm will effectively pay for that the taxpayers don't have to be saddled with
it. Finally, Donna, tell them to bring in a shopping experience like Waterbury Commons. You'll have a ton of tax revenue.
Personally, I mean, the harbor. People talk about the harbor. And, the reality of
things.
If you've
been to Myrtle Beach, I could see the harbor.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Yeah. The, what's that? The outlets. Tanger outlets.
Yes,
like Tanger outlets. If you had that at the harbor, you'd have a screaming destination on your hands.
And you could put the alligators in there and, it'd be really cool. So.
I have two more.
All right, we got to move. Go ahead.
This is Carrie Paleo of the Chamber. Just drove by the alley. No garbage, but there are some fairly big puddles. I'm not getting out there barefoot, though. And Bill Morehouse, hey, we have an awesome police chief and an awesome fire chief. We've basically been without public safety commissioner basically since I've been comptroller 11 years. The position can be eliminated. It's duplication of services, not necessary.
Ooh, so let's go back and forth with Bill on that for a second, if you don't mind.
Yeah, okay.
All right, so public safety commissioner should not be, as I said, hundreds of times the boss of the two chiefs. They're great. And we're talking about a funding line that I put in for a part-time public safety commissioner total with all the Social Security and FICA and everything, $69,000. Okay, what I want to see with that is a public safety commissioner who can shore up and actually run a proper nuisance abatement program so that when you have a Mandeville Street with 15 drug addicts actually squatting and it burns down, the fire department doesn't have to literally crawl through needles for hours to clear a building.
What you're describing is something that we probably need more than ever.
Absolutely, and that's why I'm so adamant about this. And the other thing is
it's not just about police and fire either.
Well, it's about public safety. It's about the good order of the city, right? And there's a lot of things that position should be that aren't interfering with our great police chief and fire chief.
Yeah. Lance, what does a hotel have to do with a hospital? I don't...
I responded to him. You didn't say that.
I'm not sure what that has to do with it.
Oh, you mentioned the hotels and just the fact that they're packed because of all these events.
Well, what the hotels have to do with the hospital is construction workers were...
staying?
Have been, and those working on the garage are living here.
Yeah.
And staying in our hotels. That has everything to do with the hospital and the parking garage. I mean, go to Hotel Utica sometime and have dinner. I guarantee you'll be sitting next to an engineer or a construction worker.
Yeah, and they're spending money in our city.
They're spending money here. So that's been a big boon, and now you want to see us reaping the benefits where it brings in business and that sort of thing down the road. So, all right, Mayor, good stuff.
Have a great day.
Thanks for checking out.
Oh, the parade. We got to talk about the parade.
Studio B.
At noon, we're painting the green line.
Today.
At noon today. And tomorrow we will have the parade.
10 a.m. step off for the parade. We're working on getting a hold of this wallet hub. Read my story that claims that Utica isn't even on the list of 200 of the best cities
for a celebration of St. Patrick's Day.
You know what I think?
We should be in the top 15.
After we spread shamrocks at Devereaux's grave.
That's
and
nice.
We raised the Irish flag on Wednesday, and we had the Friendly Sons of St. Patrick dinner last night, and we're painting the green line today, and we're going to have our parade tomorrow. It sure sounds like a place to celebrate, doesn't
certainly
it?
Certainly does. Yeah. It certainly does. All right, Mayor, thank you.
Thank you.
Davey, you'll escort him so he knows where to go. You can get lost down
here,
I'm telling you.
Wander around.
All right, Mayor, thank you. Let me go. Andrew, do you want to do this right now? Because he's been waiting. Jim White.
Yes, please.
Is... Okay, who is it?
Jack, he had a question for Mayor.
Oh, Jack had a question.
Oh, then we got to call. Okay. Then we have to call.
Then
Jack.
We'll. All right, Jack. Quickly, I'm sorry, I did not realize that. What was your question?
Question is with the mural that you were talking about, the area there with the new benches and everything. I noticed yesterday. I come into Utica every day, and I'm noticing a lot of the homeless people that are slapped out. You know, laying down and in bunches, sleeping and whatnot. It doesn't make the area look nice during the daytime.
What do you think?
Well, multiple things. One, it's a problem that has been on the uptick since COVID.
It's illegal. It's a legal problem.
It is a legal problem. Yeah. Now, he's not talking about panhandlers. That's a separate problem. We've had multiple meetings with the Giotto Center, for example. Groups that actually...
Which is a beautiful building.
It is. Well, here's the other thing, though. There's a lot of places that are now providing both mental health, drug addiction, and supportive services where people can find a proper path to supportive housing. And that is actually something I've been in Albany advocating for because it's something we need to take care of.
I will say this when we go to a funeral today for a guy that used to hang around radio, Fred, and was a part of the show, Fred, the human billboard. He passed away a couple of days ago, but living in squalor. Mm-hmm. And here's the problem with Fred, is that Fred, thank you, Jack, is Fred was, part of his disability was that he couldn't work with other people.
Yeah,
he would lose his cool. He would get angry. So when he's trying to get services, he gets angry and they say, you're going to treat me like that? You're done. And then they kick him to the street. Now he's living in a rat-infested, just terrible facility. I just feel like the state has just dropped the ball on mental illness.
Well, so one of the things
And there's so many of those people 100%. That are lost in the system.
So whether it's youth or young adults or aging adults with these issues, they're changing the model of how to reach people. That's why if you look at the Giotto Center, for example, there's a child side and there's an adult side. Why? Because typically when an adult needs services, if they have children or they're the guardians of somebody, they need services as well or vice versa. They're also doing things where rather than... Now, okay, it's hard enough for us to keep an appointment, right?
Yes.
Yeah. It's hard enough for us to keep an appointment. They're doing new style appointments where there's a certain amount of time coming on this day. Okay, we have an open drop-in center on a Saturday. Those types of different ways to get help to people, because the reality is you can't just round up all the homeless and put them somewhere. It's
legally,
it's a triangle. It's homelessness, it's mental health issues, and it is drug addiction.
On another note, I can tell you about the Kelberman Center.
Yes,
that is a success story. Mm-hmm. Do you know that, for instance, Stefan, who will come on, he has an apartment there. He has a cleaner that comes in to clean his apartment on a weekly basis so it doesn't get bad. Now, the important thing is, you might say, he's got a cleaner? I would like a cleaner. The reality is that cleaner actually makes him do the cleaning.
Yeah, it's cleaning coach.
It's basically a coach and a manager. And to me, we're learning and making the right moves with
a place
like the Kelberman Center.
Mayor.
So, all right, Mayor, thank you.
Thank you.
Good stuff. We will
always
break.
Good to have you.
Come right back. I want to talk about something that's also up and coming. That is the Ride for Missing Children. And then we'll wrap up this Friday morning on WIBX.
websites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. And the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
And 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
Really quickly, public hearing today at 3 for the tax waiver. That was Galime's going away message. And he'll have a program where you can run with the mayor for the Boilermaker. More details to come.
All right. All right, on the line right now, Jim has been waiting. Jim White with the Ride for Missing Children. James, good morning, and thanks so much for coming on.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
All right. When is the ride this year? What's the date?
The ride will be June 7th this year.
All right. So a lot of time, but not really. And now is the time to get in and sign up, right?
That is correct. Yep. Ride is, as we said, June 7th. We're having our first rider volunteer meeting this coming Wednesday, March 20th, 6 p.m., American Legion, post 229. That's at 409 Herkimer Road in North Utica.
Okay. What are the obligations of someone who signs up, and how do they sign up?
Well, they can sign up. They can go to our website, which is rfmc-mv.org.
Okay.
Right for Missing Children, MohawkValley.org, just the initials rfmc.mv. That has links to our Facebook page, links to our registration page, and also links to donate if they want.
All right.
Obligations, each rider is expected to raise $300. Attend training rides. New riders, no problem. We will train you. We have training rides starting in April. And we'll advise them as far as technique, equipment, and nutrition, how to get through the ride.
All right.
I got to get my big behind training and on the bike, and I got to get signed up. I'm going to do it this year, I think.
Okay. So. All right.
I got to get my bike tuned up and my behind tuned up.
Well, with everything going on, we're talking about the St. Patrick's Day Parade tomorrow at 10 and all of these things that are happening. It is important to start thinking about the Ride for Missing Children right now, so that everybody gets signed up. What a great event, and of course, raises money to print posters, which are sent out to help find kids who are missing.
Yes, and the poster, child recovery is just a part of it. There's also abduction prevention, educational material for kids, adults, and different agencies.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's all through NCMEC.
All right.
Jim. Well, we want to thank Jim and his wife, Kathy, and everybody who volunteers their time to organize this and make it a success. It's a great cause, and people got to remember the mission.
Jim, we appreciate it. Thank you, and enjoy your weekend. People, go to the website and check it out.
Yes, please.
All right, Jim. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
All right. Jim White with a Ride for Missing Children. Couple of comments. Fred in Clinton, on March 14th, 1883, Karl Marx made his most important contribution to mankind. He died. Thought I could leave with that. Actually, I got a little time, right? A little time.
John in Bridgewater, hey, Bill, among with floods comes mold in basements. That could cause issues for people. I don't know. There's a link to autism there, but...
And I know that I wanted to include 540. He's got a bunch of comments here. Let's see. The real question is, why didn't the teachers or school administration get charged or anyone else? I think they're talking about that case where the kid shot up and his parents.
Sandy Hook?
Yeah. His,
Not Sandy Hook, but the other school shooting.
The parents have been both have been found guilty. I don't know, to be honest, what they knew, but this does open an interesting can of worms, that case. It'll be something to keep an eye on. This weekend, of course, tomorrow, the big St. Patrick's Day parade. Get out there and take advantage and enjoy the festivities.
Get your Pioneers tickets.
The weather will be decent. Doesn't look like any rain tomorrow. And Pioneers, tomorrow night, tickets still available at the Adirondack Bank Center. Game time, 7 p.m.
Go Pioneers.
X950 Utica Rome. W295DI Utica Rome. Your news, talk, and sports leader. A Town Square Media Station.
This is a Fox News alert. Just out of Georgia, the news is breaking that a judge has ruled that District Attorney Fani Willis will not be disqualified from prosecuting the Trump election interference case. But she or the special prosecutor she hired would have to step down from the case. This after the romantic relationship between Fani Willis and Nathan Wade had surfaced, leading for the defense to try to get them removed from the case, claiming it is a conflict of interest. Meanwhile, there is still another Trump issue. The March 25th trial date for the criminal trial in New York could be pushed back. The former president is charged with falsifying records over 2016 hush money payments to keep an alleged affair quiet. The DA wants a 30-day delay. Trump lawyers asking for a three-month setback. There's a lot of tornado damage in three states.
The sirens went off here in Russell's Point, and about 5 minutes later, it sounded like a freight train coming through our front room.
That's in the Indian.
We were hunkered down under a blanket on the floor.
That's in the Indian Lake area of Ohio, northwest of Columbus. At least three people confirmed dead there in what's called a mass casualty event. Tornadoes also twisted areas apart in Indiana, where a lot of injuries are reported around Winchester. In Kentucky, this man's in Milton.
You know, you're shattering windows, you're damaging cars. I mean, the damage is just incredible.
Hamas has a new ceasefire proposal for Gaza that Israel's war cabinet is considering under pressure from the U.S. to stop the fighting.
Hamas is proposing a trade. It would be women, children,